This is a HeadGum Podcast.
Hey, buddy, it's Weiger. The WGA strike continues, which means no scripted intros for this episode and for the duration of this labor action. But I do have a little stat for you. Another Weiger's Neato Stat of the Week, relevant to what's going on right now. Here it is. I think this one is really just to the point. If WGA, if the Writers Guild of America, if the striking writers got everything we asked for, it would cost the studios less than 2% of the profits they make. Less than 2% of the profits. Reduced fat milk. That's what we're asking for. And that's what they're like, fuck you. We're going to shut everything down because we refuse to even negotiate. So that's my stat. Thank you to everyone who's been offering their support. And WGAContract2023.org if you want more info. And also EntertainmentCommunityFund.org. If you'd like to donate to some people who are perhaps out of work right now. Anyway, we got a fun episode for you this week as we return to Domino's.
Go with the Dodo Boys! Come on, Dodo Boys!
Welcome to Doughboys, the podcast about chain restaurants. I'm Nick Weiger, along with my co-host, Chip Van Crinkle, the Spoon Man, Mike Mitchell.
I like that one. I like it.
That was from Maddie. Yeah, that was great. not seasonally appropriate, but still just like a clever wordplay. From Maddie Two Siegs. Shout out Pineapple, Dan Arg, Elron, and Big Reg. RoastSpoonMan@gmail.com. Interesting shout outs. Yeah, Elron sounds like a Rings of Power character.
Yeah, or Scientology.
Yeah. Pineapple is just like, I guess, just a pineapple.
Yeah.
He just likes it. And then Dan Arg and Big Reg, those sound like Discord usernames.
I want to put it past our listeners to shout out like food.
Yeah.
Big shout out to like cheeseburger sliders.
Shout out to Hash Browns. Thanks for all you do.
Wags, how the hell to Spoon Nation?
Wow.
I don't know our guests too well, so it's embarrassing.
It's always
embarrassing.
I don't
know you guys too well.
Every part of this is embarrassing.
I mean, it is embarrassing always. What's going on? I've been staying up late. I told you that I
You've been having sleep problems.
I've been having sleep problems. I also did play Jedi Survivor until the sun came up.
Yeah. That's on you.
Which was bad. Yeah. Hold on. I had my notes here. Because I want to talk about two. I stayed up till 4 a.m. at one point playing Jedi Survivor, which is insane. Oh, what the fuck are you doing?
I had a fuzzy on my windscreen on my microphone.
It did right seem like you were trying to signal something, like don't talk, like, out of the
corner. Don't talk about Jedi Survivor. What the fuck you doing?
I don't think it's as good as the first one. I like the first.
Mitch, we sold an ad to EA. We can't talk about Jedi Survivor.
Look, FIFA is great. I like the FIFA games. It's good. It's not terrible.
It's tough to make a direct sequel and have it exceed the original, especially the original did something new. You know, I just had there was like a fuzzy on my mic and it was like directly in my line of sight, and so it was driving me crazy.
Okay, good. I'm glad that it's squared away.
Only one fuzzy mic I want to look at. It's you, buddy.
I liked it. You know, I like both. I liked the roast. I like that too. My other thing was, my air fryer got recalled.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I know. We talked about it on the podcast.
Yeah.
But my air fryer has like, I shouldn't say the, well, whatever. I guess you should.
Well, I also have an air fryer, so for safety, I would love to know the
Kusari air fryer.
I don't know what brand mine is.
All right.
Well, I'll look it up when I get
home. If you have a Kusari air fryer, you should check. Mine got recalled. Why? Because we talked about it on the show.
We did?
Yeah, I get to take a picture of it and cut the cord.
Cut the cord?
You got to like,
cut the cord. To take it out of society?
You need to cut the cord and take a picture of it, and then they send you like a new one.
To show that you've decommissioned it?
Yeah, Yeah.
What's it doing to people? Is it air frying?
It's overheating and can cause a fire.
There you go.
Yeah. More like air fire instead of air fryer.
Very good.
And here's another thing I was going to say.
Nailed it.
There is a stain, a tomato sauce stain. We just ate pizza.
That's right.
But on the
this week's episode.
On the I couldn't think of the name of the arms. The arms of the chairs.
Yeah, I think you'd call them arms.
The arms of the chair.
Like an armchair. the arms on an armchair.
What the fuck do you call them arms?
Yeah, they're
right?
arms.
All right, yeah, they're arms.
They're low now that my attention is brought to these arms, I'm like, whoa. Yeah.
They're low. They're low armrests here. I'm on
that's
the couch, and this
really
one's a little
high.
Bit more reasonable. Yeah.
Yeah.
These are. He gets the high ones, and we get the low ones. That's the way it goes.
You want the couch? You can have
it's
the couch.
It's in your contract that you get a full couch with high arms. there's a tomato sauce stain on the arm of this chair now.
Boy.
Which is from me, of yeah. course. And I just feel bad that, like, everyone's going to be like, yeah, it's the dope.
Yeah, the fucking HeadGum hunks. Like, fucking dope. Yeah. Do you see the tomato
scrubbing
stain?
Down the tomato sauce stain?
I think one of the doughboys like was like eating like fucking pizza while they're doing the podcast.
I think that's they were like one of the doughboys came in and it wasn't even from have the meal.
It
was just
even
sauce
related.
That was on him.
It was just he just had loose sauce just on him.
He just had loose sauce from another.
I noticed it while I was doing my planks earlier because like I was about eye level with the with the arm. So there's
you and I got to come in for that plank action. Just sit down and watch.
What's up, hunks?
They're all they monitor the doing situation. Workout, and you and I, we just take a couple seats and just sit there and watch them. Casey, would that be cool?
Sure, yeah, why not?
But that's all I had to say. There's a stain here. The Celtics play today to date this. I know that it's going to date it. But I'm nervous-wise. I think we might go into an 0-2 hole like the Lakers are in right now.
Hey, man, we'll see. We'll see. Losing two in a row at home is disastrous. So
yeah.
I think you'll get the split at least.
I hope so. We'll see what happens. Yeah.
But that Jimmy Butler, man, he's something else.
He's good.
Yeah.
He's really good.
He's good. And speaking of hunks, one of the biggest hunks there is.
I know. He's so good. He's so
physically.
Good. It's scary.
Yeah, physically. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's all we're, yeah.
Yeah.
We're talking hunks. That's all we fucking mean.
we're superficial.
Yeah. I don't care what the fuck you're saying, HeadGum hunks. Shut up. Fucking plank.
Be eye candy for me.
How you doing, Wags? You good? I am tired. I've had insomnia all week.
You've had it. Yeah, you've been dealing with that. I'm reading a book. You know what? We should have you play your drop, and we should introduce our guests because they might have a perspective on this as well. But I've been reading this book called Hello Sleep. That's about insomnia, and it's really it's really engaging and illuminating.
Is it helpful?
I mean, so far, but it's also like I'm like halfway through it, so I'm kind of waiting for the prestige. You know, I'm cutting where like okay, when are you gonna solve everything for
me? Yeah.
It's not quite there yet.
Yeah. Okay.
But it's giving a lot of interesting context in terms of what insomnia is and what leads to it, and you know, kind of also it's so of a piece with anxiety and panic in terms of, you know, when you're thinking about it, you're making it worse. So
yeah, I get that.
I have lifelong insomnia.
Wow.
Ever since I was a small child, I have not been able to sleep, and it is terrible.
Isn't it brutal? Yeah.
it's brutal.
It's been tough for me since I was about 12. When I started to become a man.
Mm-hmm.
That's when I started to like have a lot of sleeping issues.
Mm-hmm. Hey, I'm 11 years old. It's me, Wiger. Oh, shit. I'm 12.
I'm 12. I have one pube now. Now I can't sleep.
It's fucking long as hell, though.
The weight of the world falls on men.
Yeah, the mantle of masculinity.
So hard to uphold.
Weighs so much.
Who wants to see my pube? There's a huge line in the locker room.
I think
mine got worse when I was 12, too, and my mom was convinced it was because of 9/11, and that's just not true.
Younger than us.
She wants it to be that, and there's no actual reason. There's no reason.
Your mom's desperately hoping you're like
she's
just
like,
that patriotic. My daughter loves America more than anyone, actually.
Let's just say on 9/11, I had more than one pew.
Oh, yeah.
I counted that day.
We're all trying to take our mind off of things.
I remember when it happened. I mean, we shouldn't get into 9/11 talk, for God's sakes. But I remember the day it happened, and I remember, like, going to classes, and, like, I went to class. I was in college. I was a freshman in college. And I remember, like, some classes didn't know that it had happened, and I was like, I want the class to be, it was like kind of, I was like, I want the class to be canceled. What are you guys doing? You know what I mean? Like, I want them to cancel the classes. which I feel very bad about in hindsight.
Yeah.
You know, it was like being.
That's about as much perspective as I feel you can really have at 18.
Right. Yeah.
That's
for sure.
Like a very reasonable response, I think.
Also, you didn't know. I mean, look, we should.
Some of us lost sleep for the rest of their lives, but
some of us are, you know, otherwise. Insomniacs.
Class.
Sure. Instead of it just being the elephant, I thought you were going to say it was the elephant in the room. You're like, do people not know? Am I the
only that was another thing. I told our politics class. Look, we don't have to recount 9/11. It's never fun.
Are you sure? Right
to
away.
Recount 9/11.
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
We all know it was a controlled explosion. We don't need to relitigate it.
Where the fuck was Sully?
Where was Sully?
Where was Sully?
Whoa, that's a good
Sully?
Take.
A great fucking question.
Where was
question.
Sully? We won't get into.
If only Mark Wahlberg had been there.
He almost
would have been different.
No, Seth MacFarlane.
There's a Mount Rushmore of 9/11 adjacent celebrities. Mark Wahlberg said if he'd been there, it'd gone down differently.
Yeah.
Seth MacFarlane was supposed to be on the flight and missed it.
Yeah.
Supposed to be on the planes, one of the planes, and missed it. James Woods claims.
You know what
he
would do if he was on that flight?
Yeah.
You think Dish is bad? Well, you're right. Wow. Like a very solemn.
It gets a little poignant.
Oh, wow.
Well,
and none of us would ever know.
Yeah, yeah, it's, yeah, yeah. Sadly.
It's like real life Peter Griffin.
Someone on that plane would be laughing it up. Yeah.
They would have really made it better for that person.
You ever seen there's the guy, real life Peter Griffin. He's like a YouTube personality. Mm-hmm. And he like looks like Peter Griffin and he can do the voice pretty well. But he has one, he just like talks about like, you know what's really bad? Racism. And he just talks about how much he hates racism. Yeah. And all the comments are like, hell yeah, Peter Griffin. Like,
know, it's, all like that. It is good as hell.
It's good. It's really good.
Use your platform, you know?
Yeah, right. Okay, so the third one, James Woods claims he was on a rehearsal flight next to Muhammad Atta.
That's
and he
right.
observed it and he reported to the FBI and they did nothing. And then the fourth one is, of course.
He's so full of shit. I mean, it's a lie. That's insane.
The fourth one, of course, Steve Ranazzisi, who we all know thankfully survived.
Yes. Lay off the Raz man.
Lay off the Raz man.
A nice man, by all accounts.
I met him before, that's and he true. Was lovely.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Well, you just fucking lay into him on the pod.
No one's laying into him. I'm just saying, you know.
We're lucky.
Yeah.
Anyways, good to have a nice 9/11 conversation.
Yeah, great way to start the show.
I'm really glad I brought drop? It up right away.
Do you have a drop?
Yes. Emma, hit him with a drop.
Gee, I got a candy bar. Boy, I got big cookies. Hey, I got a package of gum.
I got a rock.
Trick or treat. I got a popcorn ball. I got a fudge bar.
I got a pack of gum.
I got a rock.
You're getting rocks in your food.
I didn't know
this was an occurrence.
I got a rock.
I remember this now.
Wow.
Remember is that when I bit the sandwich from the?
Oh my god!
You got a rock.
I had a rock in my sandwich. Uh-huh.
That's maybe one of the worst ways to discover it: biting into a sandwich.
Oh, it was awful.
What did you expect to be in the sandwich?
Like turkey or whatever. Fuck! It was like a chicken. I think it was a chicken. So it was just at the airport.
In all fairness, they thought you were a Goron.
It was pre-packaged. They didn't see me and think I was a Goron.
What was
give
the size
me a
of
rock
the rock
sandwich?
How big was
it? It was like a pebble, but it was so weird that it was a rock.
That is weird.
That is
like,
weird.
How did a rock get in there?
I have no
great
idea.
Question.
A weird, what? Like a pebble in the sandwich. It was, I mean, like I had it in my hand.
Wow.
It's like, did someone just have pebbles in their shirt that day that they were just shaking
they'd
them out?
They'd gone to the beach and they made a sandwich right after.
That's what it was.
I mean, but it was like, oh man, I still think about it because it was like the closest I think I ever came to cracking my tooth.
Yeah, you don't want to be a rock biter. It's no fun.
That's what happened.
That's what happens.
A fucking crunch.
That's that Vince Guaraldi score and that Charlie Brown special. Oh my goodness.
Great.
Great vibes. Oh. Impeccable vibes.
You and me, I mean, it was like Charlie Brown. Like a little part of my soul just was right there.
Beautiful. Mm-hmm.
Lovely.
Good grief.
Good grief.
Good grief.
The old Charlie Brown saying, my boyfriend got me into the podcast and now here I am making drops. This one might be good for October. or anytime. And features the classic Peanuts holiday special, It's the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown. As the kids go trick-or-treating, Charlie Brown memorably keeps getting a rock tossed into his treat bag.
Yes.
Much like an airport sandwich once consumed by Mitch. We remembered it, Sarah. Audio from episode 17, Subway, with Fran Gillespie.
That long ago. That far back in our past.
Sarah, Austin, Texas. Thank you, Sarah.
Wow, thanks, Sarah. Yeah, we had a Halloween
keep
drop.
Keep
Austin cool. We had a Halloween drop, and we had a Christmas roast. Very seasonally inappropriate today.
Christmas roast.
All right, stop licking your lips, buddy. Let's introduce our guests. Two hosts of the podcast, Too Scary, Didn't Watch. Emily Gonzalez and Henley Cox are here. Hi, Emily. Hi, Henley.
Hello. Thank you for having us. We're so excited to be here.
Thank you so much for joining us. For audio listeners, Emily's here in studio. Henley, you're in NYC, the city that never sleeps.
Yeah, and that's a perfect place for me. It ends up.
Yeah, I was going to say, fucking insomnia capital.
That's true. What is the, now, which of the five boroughs are you in? We talking Manhattan, Queens, Brooklyn, the Bronx, or Staten Island?
Nice. Ooh.
Wow. He got them all. Manhattan. So I'm in Washington
Heights.
Yeah,
fucking cool, right?
That is
cool. Pretty fucking cool.
I am very, very, very north Manhattan. So by anyone who's familiar, Fort Tryon Park, the Cloisters, George Washington Bridge, that area. So technically Manhattan, but, you know, almost out. Wow. Almost away. Almost gone. From the city itself.
Are you an enthusiast of the choo-choo? Because when I go to the New York City, that my favorite thing to do is to ride the subway.
Oh, boy.
Okay. The subway, of course, I'm a huge fan of.
We're baby boys. Yeah. Do you like the choo-choo?
Of course. I was like,
Is
he talking about the subway? I've never heard anyone call it the choo-choo
like
before.
You sound cool. He likes the subway.
No,
you're embarrassing yourself in front of a New Yorker. It's embarrassing.
Yeah. Now, of course I do. I mean, it's a public transit system that so many people use and is actually extremely effective, which is very rare in this. I mean, it doesn't really exist in a lot of other places in this country. So for that reason, I'm a huge fan. But I'm not a huge fan of is kind of like the falling apart infrastructure of the city itself.
Sure.
And the fact that the trains like are constantly breaking down. And
yeah, that's a bummer.
There's being underground is a real freaky place for things to start falling apart. I wouldn't want it.
Yeah.
Yes. Wouldn't want it. And it's a big social experiment to be trapped on a train with a lot of strangers during rush hour.
Right.
And a lot of chaos can happen. But that's also rare. I kind of love that. I love that about being in New York, being able to like be with people. I lived in LA for 5 years and very different experience, obviously, being in a car all the time.
Yeah, I take the train out here as much as I can. I take the bus out here, but it is much less of you're talking about infrastructure. The infrastructure out here, it just like goes fewer places. You're a lot more limited. And because it's a much more sprawling, the city is much larger and everything's more spread out. It's just like, there's just situations where it's like, well, fuck it. I just got a driver that's going to take me three times as long, which kind of sucks. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do things run differently in Staten Island since it's a monarchy?
Of course. I've only been to Staten Island once. I've only been one time. but it's a different, it's like a different reality out there. I mean, I think that things are very different. But taking the ferry is like a very fun experience, and anyone who comes here should absolutely do it because it's great to be on the water.
Staten Island, a lot of bupkis.
That's true. there's bupkis.
There's
out
a
there.
Fucking bupkis going on out there. It's no good.
Emily, before we started, you were telling me that you like Casey are from South Florida.
Yes.
And Henley, I want to hear where you're from as well. But I'm curious, like South Florida, what's the food scene like there? But down there, is there anything you miss?
Okay, you know what I miss is there is like a drive-through. Okay, so let's see if this connects with you. There's a drive-through like fast food Cuban spot. Pollo Tropical.
Oh yeah, Pollo Tropical.
Casey remembers.
I do remember that. Yeah,
so good. Just like beans and rice and plantains and like pork or chicken, and it's just so fucking good. And it's just like casual. Like the way we do like drive-through burritos, but it's Cuban food and it totally rules.
And just like you get a plate.
You get a plate. You mainly get a plate. I mean, I don't think I've had it in probably 15 or 20 years.
That's a but long that's time. I hope it's still
basically,
there.
Basically, no, it's. I think it is because it's like very near my parents. There's one, and I used to like. That was like on my way back from ballet class. We would like you could go to the drive-thru and like have your put a tropical on it.
Ballet class. I have fond memories. My sister had ballet class.
Mm. Wow.
As a younger brother, like we would go pick my sister up from ballet class, my mom and I. And it would always be like we get like some sort of good food.
Yes, I like really was like, okay, we all just like exercise. It's usually late, right? It's like after school. I would class would be like 5:30 to 6:30. So it's like, let's just go to the drive-thru.
Mm-hmm.
What was your favorite ballet move?
To do?
Yeah.
Can I guess?
Yes. I don't know the answer, so let's see if that sparks anything for me.
Handstand.
Not a ballet move. Yeah. In fact, really just very far from any ballet.
What I was going to guess, I was going to say a triple axel. I was like, that's figure skating.
That is figure skating, but honestly somehow closer to ballet than a handstand. Yeah. Yeah.
They say figure skating is the ballet of the ice swag. So that's what they say.
Yeah. They're always saying that.
I'm sorry about my idiot friend saying something so fucking stupid. Was your favorite move a backflip?
Field goal.
Oh, I got one.
Field goal.
Yeah. Wow, favorite move.
I got one. A pirouette.
Pirouette.
You know what? Pirouette's kind of scary.
Ooh. How about a plié?
Hard. A plié is classic.
Okay, got it.
You know, yeah. Who doesn't like a plié? Yeah.
Scary is your wheelhouse.
That's a great point, Mitch.
Great segue. It is actually, so the thing is, Henley and I are two of three. We have a third host, Sammy Smart, who is our resident brave person. So the whole podcast is she basically tells us what happens in scary movies.
But not brave enough for the Doughboys podcast.
Not brave enough.
That's a bridge too far.
Fast food? No. So I am like, I'd say like I'm like right in between Henley and Sammy in terms of being able to handle scary stuff.
Wow.
But still, I would not call myself that brave.
I think you're very brave, by the way, for the record. For the record, Emily's not going to toot her own horn here, but I think that your tolerance for the scare has increased.
It has gone up.
Dramatically.
I bet maybe similar to, I would imagine over time, a tolerance goes up for a certain quality of food.
Well, kind of love it to begin with.
We are also all aging, and so that's working against you, you know?
Yeah.
But my tolerance has gone up.
Wow. Wags, they said some kind of things back and forth. I want to say to you that you are the most cowardly man I've ever met. has there ever been a movie that you truly could not finish because it was too scary?
Oh, I have so many feelings about this. Okay,
there
have been so many movies that I have not wanted to finish, but I have been a good friend and a good podcast host, and I've fucking done it. The only one where I had to take the headphones off and just not listen at all was Human Centipede. That was really hard to listen to. That was a hard
one. Those are really gross. That's also like the gross category of like, it's like, this is like, we're like hearing about it. To a butthole.
That's exactly what they do.
And Sammy, our other host, is a maniac and a complete sicko and fucking loves Human Centipede and has seen it a bunch of times and thinks it's hilarious. And so she spared like no detail. And she does that to us. It's cruel and unusual punishment. She's also like my best friend and I love her so goddamn much. But
I've never seen Human Centipede, but I know what happens. And also I know those kind of like gross out / body horror movies are a lot. For me, it's like, still to this day, watching Exorcist late night, I'll be like, ooh, this is fucking scary.
Yeah. Because you're a big horror fan, and that one's still too tough for you.
That's a scary
one.
But you're also like very, like, that's a religious thing.
It's right in my
devil. Oh, okay.
Like,
religious ones,
the devil scares me.
Demons, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
South Park the movie.
Uh-huh.
There's like there's some, like, Little Nicky. There's a lot of stuff that scares
Little
me.
Little Nicky.
But I think, like, possession, ghostly stuff. I believed in it for so long. I mean, I still don't not believe in it. Sure.
You don't not?
I don't not believe in it.
Is it because you don't want to, on the off chance that they're real, you don't want to put out in the world that you don't believe? Because it's inviting something in?
I think my thought is that, like, there's Look, we talked about this before, is like that sort of thing of being agnostic or whatever. It's like you don't know what's in the universe. But sure. For me, so often when someone dies or you've been in a place where like someone has died, you can feel that energy. And I'm like, oh, I believe that there can be energy where something has happened or something bad happened, or there is like, so I don't know if what I'm saying is I don't know if I completely believe in like hauntings of like a ghost, a white sheet ghost. Being like, like that haunting, though that is also scary. But I think that I can believe in like, oh, someone died sad or mad or whatever. And there's like the energy in this house.
Behind. Yeah.
There's been, you know how you've been places and you're like, there's energy here that's weird.
Mm-hmm. Well, Henley absolutely. Very much doesn't believe in ghosts. So, but I agree with you.
It's a strong stance that I have. Sure. And I've been testing the limits of it by constantly inviting a haunting. I'm saying, bring it. If it's going to happen, just let it happen.
She says it all. She really doesn't believe it. She says it all the time. It hasn't been haunted yet.
It's because I have been so, earlier in my life when I was a child, I was so desperately scared of it that now it's like, I've got to, I can't live my life that way. I refuse. Nah.
If you were by yourself in like an abandoned hospital, would that not scare you?
Of course that would scare me.
Well, then why?
Of course that would scare me.
According to you, why would that scare you?
That's a great point.
No, okay, listen, this is a strength of will thing, obviously. Refuse to accept that there are ghosts because otherwise my entire world would crumble. I can't walk around like that. Also, as an insomniac, I am up in the middle of the night often. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so at 3 a.m. in my living room with all the lights off, I can't be thinking about ghosts. You kidding?
Yeah. Yep.
No. Did I ever tell my one? Should I tell this story? Did I ever tell this on this podcast? I think I did.
Just tell it.
When I first moved to LA and I lived in a producer's house.
Uh-huh. Well, you've told one aspect of the story, but I don't think it's where you're going.
Okay. It's not that part of the... Yeah. I've told you that one.
Okay, yeah, we will. Sorry,
have I never said it on the podcast?
I don't know if it's been said in the pod.
A producer asked me to suck his dick. Yeah.
Oh, God.
Politely?
Yeah, I did it.
And then we started a podcast called Doughboys. Got to jump through the hoops.
Nick Weiger, host and producer. I don't know if you ever noticed that in this title. Yeah, suck this thing to start the pot. All right, this is how it goes in Hollywood. I was staying at this house.
Yeah,
and I remember the person there was my boss went to like overseas, and then his assistant was leaving, and I was like, "Is there anything you want to tell me about this?" Because it was an old house in Hollywood. I won't say who it is. I'm not going to dox him anymore. I hope I've never said his name on the podcast where I told this story before. I was like, is there anything you want me to tell me about this? He was like, what do you mean? And I was like, is the house haunted? And he was like, the house wasn't that old.
Uh-huh.
And he was like, I'll tell you when you get back. And I was like, no.
Well, you basically just told me.
Yeah, yes. I was like, you got to tell me now, because I was upstairs in the room. I was like, is there like some sort of woman? This is the truth. I was like, is there some sort of woman? And he's like, why do you say that? And I was like, I don't know. I keep waking up in the middle of the night. This is the truth. I was waking up at like in the middle of the night and feeling a weird thing. And then he told me a story that like people had seen a lady in the house a bunch. And the nephew of the producer followed it upstairs. And she walked into a room and disappeared. And I was like, what room was it? And it was the guest room that I was staying in. So
wow,
I just want to tell you. That's at least what he told me, and I did say to him like, "What's going on in here? Is it haunted?"
You felt something.
So I felt something weird. Now, look, does that mean that the ghosts are real? That someone saw a lady ghost? I don't know. I wasn't there. I didn't see the lady ghost, but there was definitely something that I felt, and I weirdly was like, "Is there some lady here?" And I don't think I have ESP powers or something.
They said a waiter went up to their table and told. What was that?
What the fuck?
What just happened? I just heard my voice.
I know. I looked around. I was that like, was he's my not.
But I wasn't talking.
Ghost. Ghost.
We had an
it was
Emma
a ghost.
Who?
It was a ghost.
We had a ghost in the machine.
A ghost in the machine? Am I alive?
It's a
Did Nick Weiger
situation.
Die 10 years ago this day?
Oh, man. fucking fumbling around on the podcast solo. but that is a true story. I felt a weird thing, and I asked if it was some lady, and he said yes, who disappeared in the room. But look, I don't know what that means. I don't know if someone even saw a lady. I don't know if that's true.
Yeah, sure.
All I know is that I kept waking up, and then I had a weird thing about some lady being in the house, and it was, and that's what people claim to be. Was he fucking with me? I don't think so. I don't think he was.
Mm.
He maybe he was. Who knows? He could have been.
The way you're describing it, it doesn't sound like it.
No. Yeah.
It was weird. It was one of the weirdest experiences I've ever had, but I never saw anything. I never saw, but then from there on out, I moved down into his room because the producer's assistant lived in the house too, and I wasn't staying in the guest room, and he had his own room, and then I moved down into, it was a weird setup, and I stayed in his room, and then like the rest of, they were gone for like 2 weeks, and I would be in the house being like, hello, like, I know you're here, just don't, like, show yourself. That's what I would say.
Yes, whenever I enter somewhere that I'm, like, it feels scary to me. Basically, anywhere that's, like, when I stayed in New Orleans and it, like, was an old place, and I was like, well, this is a haunted city.
Down in the
I'll
bayou.
Just, I'll say,
ooh, that's a gator ghost.
I'll just go, like, hey, I'm not going to mess with you. I'm coming and going. Please don't show yourself to me, and we're good.
That's
just in case.
You've had a ghost experience.
That's smart.
You had a ghost experience?
Okay. I don't know if I did.
Everyone says that who has a ghost experience. But it feels like
I saw what looked like a person when I was staying in a hotel in the middle of the night. And I woke up and I was really, really scared. It was middle of the night and I eventually fell back asleep. And I woke up again and looked and saw the person again in the same spot. And then they felt like they looked at me. And then I turned the lights on, and there was like nothing in that corner that looked like the shape of a man. It's just scary. But now in hindsight, I'm like, was I just very tired? Like, I don't know. I don't know. You know,
of course, sleep paralysis. Yeah. I never had sleep paralysis, and then I thought there was a tarantula on my wall. You know this, Wags.
Mm-hmm.
And Jack Allison got a tennis racket.
Your roommate at the time.
And then he was like, oh, you were having like a dream.
Yeah.
But I never had sleep paralysis, but I have friends. Justin Kiley and Dan Tufo, like Dan Tufo had a sleep paralysis where there was an old lady at the foot.
Oh, yeah. No, I used to have sleep paralysis. God. That used to be like a once a month thing for me. Now, thankfully, it's few and far between, but it's real fucking scary. And yeah, I would often have, I could never see their face, but just a hulking figure at the foot of my bed, like looking over, like
once a month.
That's
scary.
Yeah, that's roughly like that would happen. But also a lot of times I would
Are you sure you're not thinking about that time I sucked you off to get the Doughboy's
that's
job?
That's what, you know what? That's what it was.
Trauma nightmares.
but also a lot of times when I would have it, I would be like face down on my pillow. And so like I couldn't move and I was face down and I couldn't feel like I could get air in my lungs and it was just totally immobile. And so those times were, that was actually scarier than seeing.
Yeah.
Also, you've been haunted by like food from the show. Like there was like a floating slice of pizza.
Yeah. It's a big cheeseburger, bowl of gumbo. Remember me from the bayou?
Gator ghost is pretty fun.
Gator
ghost might be a fun.
Yeah, that'd be fun. Yeah,
that's like at least a sci-fi movie.
Yeah, they should absolutely make Gator ghost. I was talking to a guy on the fucking picket line who was like involved with Sharknado.
Wow.
Nice. And he was like, we had no, like I was just at Sci-Fi Network at the time. He was just like, oh yeah, we were making this thing called Sharknado. And no one had any fucking idea. And it just becomes this huge, like they made like 7 of them.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say like, the guy who worked on Sharknado, he's going to be like, yeah, it's real, you know. Sharknado exists.
Fuck.
We did not make that up.
Yeah, we just filmed it.
It's a documentary.
Henley, I'm curious because I do want to talk about your podcast and I do want to talk horror a little bit, but I'm curious just to get a little background of you specifically. Like, where are you from and do you have any favorite foods from growing up?
So I'm from Maryland and I'm from a very, very small town in the middle of nowhere that's on the Chesapeake Bay. And the thing that Maryland is known for, which I didn't know growing up wasn't ubiquitous everywhere, is crabs. So
yes, right.
I grew up eating a shit ton of crab, and it's a really strange experience. Do you guys ever eat crabs? The thing
much less for me, New England. It's the lobster versus crab dynamic that we have.
Got it. But it's the same kind of thing. Like,
sure,
you're getting this terrifying hard-shelled underwater spider. Put in front of you, and it's like a fun social activity to
crack it
crack
open
it
and
open.
Pull out its body.
It's pretty, yes. it's very caveman-y.
Yeah.
We talked about this on the podcast. We used to like, you'd race lobsters and stuff. Like you get lobsters and then like you'd like put them on the floor and like they're running against each other.
Well, time to boil them alive. Lobsters are a different because we would never cook our own crabs. I mean, people certainly do that, but lobsters, I feel like you always were cooking them yourself. You'd be plopping the live thing in the pot.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a very intense experience.
That's hard. I mean, now we get them cooked and then we heat them up because we don't want to. We feel bad doing it. I mean, we still are killing them.
Yeah, but it's tough to see it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I'd like to think that the guys at Burke Seafood put them to sleep and then toss them in the pot.
Put them in a little chokehold and then
have them tap out. Yeah.
Do you like crab or have you just eaten a lot of it?
I do really like it. I still really like it.
Are you like an Old Bay person? Like, how do you have your crab?
Yeah, love Old Bay. Love melted butter. I'm not a pro at breaking them up open and kind of getting in there. Some people are, I mean, it's really a point of pride. Some people don't need to use any kind of tools to do it. They do it all with their hands.
Wow.
And they can, you buy like dozens of crabs and people can sit there for hours and just eat them and chat and like drink beer. And my first job when I was 14, I worked at a crab house and I did that for 3 summers in a row. Where my whole job was literally just like putting cardboard paper down on tables.
Wow.
Watching people consume so much beer and just decimate a shit ton of crabs and then have to clean it all up afterwards. And that smell like lingers with me and haunts me a little bit because it was very strong.
Yeah, right.
But also, I loved it. It was so super fun. And I still go back to that same restaurant all the time. And it's where my rehearsal dinner was for my wedding. Yeah.
Hey, that's great.
Wow. That's very cool.
Yeah. 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 So I feel like I have I'm kind of a snob about it. I won't eat crabs except in my hometown.
Wow.
Really.
Wow. I love
yeah.
it. Yeah. You got to be a little, you know, when you know it, you got to be a little snobby about it. Why not? Mm-hmm. I like it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I'm always a little like skeptical when I'm seeing crab cakes, you know, in like Indiana. Like, I don't know.
Sure.
Guys.
How is this gonna be? Here's something that ties the two things we're talking about together. You guys ever see Crawl?
the alligator movie?
Yeah. That's a scary
one.
We did one.
Crawl.
We covered
Talk about
it. We did
being
not
haunted.
See it. Yeah. We didn't see it. We had it described to us, but that's actually one of our early lost episodes. The audio first episodes. The audio got totally fucked up. Mm-hmm. And so we can never, it's like we already know what happens so that we can't re-record it. The whole thing is, we know what happens in Crawl, but nobody else will know.
Scary as hell. Did you guys see
it? It was scary.
Yeah, I loved it. I loved Crawl. Emma, were you about to say something about Crawl or were you about lost audio?
It was more about lost audio. If you still have the fucked up files, I'd try to fix them for you.
Wow.
Oh my God. I mean,
no promises.
Do it.
That's a boss move. I don't know
that
if we do or not.
Cool.
Sammy
I have
would.
No idea. It was so long ago. Loss of limbs is really bad for me. That's like my least favorite thing to happen in a scary movie. So there's some of that in Crawl. I mean, that you gotta. But so that part's tough for me.
Yeah. Yeah. There's some gnarly stuff. I love Crawl. Did you ever see Crawl? Oh, you'd like
it. It was like one of your favorites. Yeah, you like that a lot.
Crawl's good.
Do you both like horror movies? Or
so Mitch is more of the horror guy than me. But I appreciate it.
Nick makes like real life horror movies.
What does that mean?
And proof of life videos, that sort of thing.
Remember like the scene with Buffalo Bill from Silence of the Lambs?
Oh, right.
That's kind of what he's got going on.
Hey, buddy. You fuck me, I'd fuck me.
Was she a great big plump person, buddy? We've done this exact thing before.
We've definitely done this bit. Here's what we should do, because we got to talk about these Domino's tots, because that's the order of the day. So let's take a break. We're going to come back. We're going to have some more Doughboys that Too Scary Didn't Watch right after this.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy, the Spoon Man. Our next partner is Athletic Greens. I take AG1 by Athletic Greens literally every day. I gave AG1 a try because I wanted better gut health. Why? Because I wanted my gut to feel good.
Right.
And immune system support. AG1 covers that too, but I hated taking pills, vitamins, and wanted a supplement that actually tastes great.
Mitch, when do you take AG1?
Wigs, I'm glad you ask. I take AG1 in the morning, and the morning for me.
Mm-hmm.
I put it into a big glass of water, I stir it up, drink it down, and I'm covered for the day. And it makes me feel like, you know what? It makes me feel like Superman. I feel invincible.
Wow.
That's right. I feel like I've gotten everything I need in the day. It's covered. It's like when you get your exercise in the morning, you know how you got everything covered?
Oh, yeah.
That's when you take AG1 in the morning. You got everything you need for the day in one big gulp. And sometimes I put it in my Greek yogurt smoothie. You know this. But Wags, it's hard for me to keep up with the supplement routine that comes with a bunch of different products. But AG1 makes that so much easier. Very quickly, I noticed that it helped me with, sorry to get gross here, improved digestion.
Ew.
I know. And, you know, my hair and skin, how do they look? They feel great, and it supports sleep. It does everything for you.
Why take a bunch of different things when you can just mix one scoop of powder and water once a day?
AG1 was designed with ease in mind so you can live healthier and better without having to do a lot. It's the healthiest thing you can do in under a minute.
AG1 is powerful because it's so easy to fit into your lifestyle. It's one scoop of powder mixed with water once a day.
AG1 has been a part of millions of mornings since 2010, and AG1 gives you increased energy and mood support, making it easy to live your best life.
AG1 is delivered every month, so it's super easy to make it a daily habit. And also, you get the single-serving travel pack so you never have to miss a day. Just mix the powder into ice-cold water and drink it first thing in the morning. That's it.
With AG1, taking good care of your body each day is really that simple.
If you're looking for an easier way to take supplements, Athletic Greens is giving you a free one-year supply of vitamin D and 5 free travel packs with your first purchase. Go to athleticgreens.com/doughboys.
That's athleticgreens.com/doughboys. Check it out.
You know, Mitch, you just took a trip to Costa Rica.
That's right, Wags. I was just in Costa Rica with my mom and sister and my godparents' family. It was a blast.
Well, you know, it can be helpful down there. A little Espanol.
Wags, I wish I knew more.
Well, if you have an upcoming summer trip abroad, my go-to travel hack is Babbel. Whether you're a seasoned traveler or embarking on your first adventure, communication is key to fully experiencing a new culture. That's where Babbel comes in.
Babbel is a language learning app that sold more than 10 million subscriptions, and thanks to Babbel's addictively fun and easy bite-sized language lessons, there's still time to learn a new language before you reach your destination.
I love the little Babbel lessons because they're very quick, they're very engaging. You can do them on the go, you can do them from home, you can do them on your computer, you can do them on the app. And with Babbel, you only need 10 minutes to complete a lesson, so you can start having real-life conversations in as little as 3 weeks.
Wow. Babbel's expertly crafted lessons are built around real life. You learn how to have a practical conversation about travel, relationships, business, and more.
Other language learning apps use AI for their lesson plans, but Babbel lessons were created by over 150 language experts and voiced by real native speakers, not computers.
Their teaching method has been scientifically proven to be effective, and with Babbel, you can choose from 14 different languages.
Plus, Babbel's speech recognition technology helps you to improve your pronunciation and accent. There are so many ways to learn with Babbel. In addition to lessons, you can access podcasts, games, videos, stories, and even live classes. Plus, it comes with a 20-day money-back guarantee.
Start your new language learning journey today with Babbel.
Right now, get up to 55% off your subscription when you go to babbel.com/doughboys. That's babbel.com/doughboys for up to 55% off your subscription. That's babbel.com/doughboys for up to 55% off your subscription. Babbel, language for life. Welcome back to Doughboys. We are here with Emily Gonzalez and Henley Cox of Too Scary Didn't Watch, discussing Domino's Tots. Now, let me give our history with Domino's real quick, Mitch, because we've covered
also, quick question, just to go back to it. Do you remember how many pubes you had on 9/11?
I do think we should keep talking about
9/11. Yeah, let's keep bringing that up. Between 9 and 11, somewhere in that range. We first reviewed, Mitch, what was our biggest episode for like the first 2 years of the podcast? Domino's with Matt.
So your answer is 10?
Yeah.
10 pubes?
Yeah, okay. That's,
you know. Give or take.
Yeah. Okay.
A little margin for error. Matt Kowalik reviewed
the
it
Noid
first in 2015.
The Noid himself.
We had the first ever Domino's pizza chef, you may remember, on Doughboys Double,
do
Joe
remember.
Quasarano.
Mm-hmm.
It was fascinating to conversation with him. Mm-hmm. We last reviewed it with Jamel Bowie in 2020, and we can announce Jamel will be joining us for our live show in Washington, D.C.
Wow.
On Thursday, June 8th.
Woo!
So look for that.
Wow.
He'll be one of our guests. And also it won Munch Madness, the Tournament of Champions, The Slice is Right. We are Domino's fans. And
Both of y'all were like, I don't want to say emphatic, but you were like excited about the idea of talking about Domino's.
We're big Domino's fans. Correct?
You're big Domino's fans. Yeah. Yeah.
Especially like particularly in our friend group, there was a stretch of time when Henley lived in LA where like pretty much every time we would hang out, we would get Domino's pizza.
Wow.
Every time.
So it's like, it's both something that it's something we love, but I also like, it like feels nice for me.
Was it a childhood favorite of yours? Like, what is the connection?
It was not a childhood favorite of mine. I feel like Domino's Pizza used to be really bad. Do you guys remember when Domino's Pizza got good?
Oh, yeah. No, they had a whole campaign.
Like, wow. They had a whole campaign. They, like, changed their recipe. Mm. They changed. They got that the super garlicky, buttery crust situation going on.
Here's the thing.
Natalie doesn't love the new sauce, by the way. Natalie, we sub in the sauce. She thinks the new sauce is not as good as the old sauce.
So you go original sauce?
Yeah, go original sauce, yeah.
You know what? I should try the original sauce and see how it stacks up.
Can you?
Oh, yeah. No,
yeah, they have it as an option. Yeah.
Great. I was like, my ice gone. Yeah. I got it.
Call Domino's and be like, give us the old sauce.
I want the old recipe.
Yeah. We're old, so we remember when Domino's was good the first time.
That's right.
Oh, interesting.
Like, I remember as a boy getting Domino's and Domino's being good.
We were a Pizza Hut family or a Roundtable Pizza family. Yeah.
I feel like Pizza Hut didn't deliver when I was younger.
Mm. This is the thing. My dad, so thrifty, never got delivery. I don't think we got delivery once in my entire time as a child.
I don't remember getting much delivery either. Someone would go,
pick it up.
Yeah.
I lived so far away from anything that no one would deliver to us except for Domino's.
Wow.
There you go.
Domino's was the only place that would deliver, and I would fucking like stay home from school, like pretend to be sick, and then just like call Domino's for delivery.
That's great.
And
wow, that's awesome.
Spend all the money I had on eating Domino's like alone in my living room with my cats.
This sounds like a look into my childhood too. But did you ever do the thing where you put the thermometer against like a light?
I would go under the sink. That's hot water under the sink. Yeah,
that's much smarter.
I never did that.
I did it to the light.
Literally never.
No, my mom was a nurse. She would have known what I was up to.
My mom was a nurse, and she was like, "You have like 125 degree temperature."
I don't think it ever actually worked.
It would do like 107.
Thing with hot water. That was
the hospital. Yeah,
couldn't get that in. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And I also could never read like old school thermometers. I couldn't read. In fact, I don't know if I still could now.
Me either.
It's a good challenge.
No, with the dots?
The thing goes like, zoop, you know?
Yeah. I feel like with like modern thermometer, I think I would, but you got to have it in your mouth, right? Like it's got to be
in your mouth, or they got the ear ones too.
Fuck that shit.
You don't like the ear?
No, I don't like the ear thermometer.
Give me the ear. If I go to the doctor's office, I love the ear.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because it's fast. It's a fast read.
Yeah.
No, I'm a mouth guy.
And they don't have to put the like plastic thing over the thing and put it in your mouth. You know,
you're a mouth guy.
At the doctor, they like you're when you go in for an exam, like the doctor counts up your pubes as well, right?
Quick pubes inventory.
Is your doctor Nick?
All right. So I'm curious with the two of y'all, you get together, you're going to force yourselves to watch The Conjuring or whatever to make it into content. You're ordering a Domino's pizza. What's your typical order?
Ooh, good question.
Ooh. I just love a cheese Domino's pizza. I feel like we never really went big with toppings, just cheese. And we would get the little bread bites, the little Parmesan bread bites.
The thing that's absolutely key that you cannot, I personally cannot not have is the ranch.
You gotta have the ranch.
Dipping cup
they have a
is
great ranch there.
Yeah.
So important to me when it comes to Domino's.
The garlic butter.
I like that garlic butter too.
The garlic butter is also nice.
Yeah.
But the ranch is absolutely a must.
I get both. Yeah. And you know what? It's surprising that those tots didn't come with any dipping sauces.
Those tots. Mm. I mean, are we going to talk about the tots?
We're going to talk about the tots.
Yeah. My God. As a true Domino's fan, I'm let down.
I have a lot of thoughts here. I'm going to say this. I remember when Domino's was first started doing sides, Wags, which you'll remember too. I think you'll remember this. Gotta be Domino's wings.
Yeah.
Remember that? That was when Domino's had buffalo wings.
Oh.
Then they went into like bread. I think maybe they had breadsticks at that point, like just like kind of plain breadsticks, but cheesy bread. I always get a cheesy bread. I like the cheesy bread.
The cheesy bread is fucking good.
The cheesy bread is really good. And for me, I'll usually do, I'll either do a pan pizza, which is like their Pizza Hut version of pizza, or a thin crust pizza. I never do, I do one of those two.
They have that thin crust veggie one. We would always get that too, that thin crust like Mediterranean veggie.
Oh yeah, the thin crust is good, yeah.
Yeah, that one's good.
And now, so I'll do either thin crust or pan, and then I'll do half pepperoni and green pepper, half sausage and onion. That's what I do.
You know, it's a good one. We get there pretty regularly. We usually do a thin crust, but we'll also do one of the five boroughs, a Brooklyn style, which was a promotional one they brought out, and they've kind of kept on the menu. I think people forget about Brooklyn style. Brooklyn style is great.
What do we got? What's happening with that?
It's like a, you know, it's
like
a little thinner
slice?
Yeah, it's kind of like a midpoint between their regular, their default crust, and then the thin crust. So, and
you come to
like,
Brooklyn, you gotta get Domino's. That's
it's just like you're in New York.
Yeah, my husband is a New Yorker, and he really looks down upon my love of Domino's.
I know. He used to judge us, and I'll never forgive him.
Okay, guys. Oh, God, I've eaten so much Domino's in my life because it's also my main number one drunk food. And
wow.
They're open late, usually.
Yeah.
And so, and when I was in L.A., there was a Domino's at the bottom of my hill where I lived, and they had a takeout window. The store would close, but the window would stay open till super late. And there were many a nights where I would have my Uber just drop me off right at that Domino's, and I would pick up my pizza and then walk up the hill.
Which was a serious hill. That's how much you wanted the Domino's. That is not an easy hill to do at the end of the night.
Hell yeah. And Tim, my husband, would always be like, "Oh, you know, I don't want Domino's. No, I don't want any. No, no. You better believe I'm getting a large Domino's pizza because he's eating half of that, no matter how much he protests."
Yes, yeah.
You can't have Domino's in your presence and not want to eat it.
Yeah, that's very hard to. Yeah. It's come on. I mean, we got pizzas with the tots today. We didn't save you any.
I really regret it. I was like, you should. I didn't do it, and it was a mistake.
Yeah, I mean. That's why it's hard to review just the are we just reviewing the tots?
I think we're talking tots today. I mean, we could talk more general. We can give a general fork score for Domino's, but I think the order of the day is these new tots, which are a thing they're really pushing. And part of their marketing is they're like, oh, fries don't deliver, but you know what delivers well is tots, which makes me want to get everyone's opinions on tots in general. Because I feel like we're kind of like tots.
Are you hot to tot?
Are you hot to tot? For a long time, it felt like they were like, it was just like a school lunch thing, or it was like a frozen bag thing. And then they're like, it felt like they started showing up at gastro pubs and then back at fast food restaurants again.
I really do think tots are having a moment.
They're having a moment, yeah.
Yeah.
I like them, but then I also feel like so many, like, it does annoy me when people are like, I actually like tots the most. I'm like, shut up.
Shut up, you fucking doughboys listener.
Shut up, you fucking, yeah, you are.
I think the tots taste better than fries. I think the doughboys should review tots.
Yeah. Shut up. Fries are better. Look, I'm going to say it. Fries are better than tots. Yeah. I'm sorry.
I like fries better than tots, but I like tots.
I like fries better than tots as well.
Tots are just like, I don't know. I mean, like, I guess they're close to breakfast.
Going to say tots are like hash brownie. And you know where, like, tots is in a breakfast burrito.
That's
better than
that's
a
great.
Fry is a tot in a breakfast burrito. Because it's kind of, it smushes and it's more salt per surface area.
Breakfast burrito, yes, but California burrito.
The California burrito is good.
Now we're talking fries.
Yeah.
We're talking fries.
Now we're talking fries again.
Look, Henley, would you characterize yourself as hot to tot?
Tots aren't bad. I don't want to get people mad.
Tots aren't bad. The doughboys think tots are bad. Shut the fuck up.
Fucking kick the shit. I didn't fucking punt you.
We're
mad at our listener. Sorry. This fake listener. Okay, yeah, go ahead.
I feel pretty middle of the road on tots, but I will agree that they're absolutely having a moment. I was at a bar a couple weekends ago that's like a cool trendy bar in New York that has a small bites menu, and half of their small bites menu is loaded tots. Like they're different varieties of tots with like a Mediterranean spin, like a shawarma tot.
Oh, that's
a shawarma tot.
I think that people have come to the conclusion we can put whatever the fuck we want on these tots, and like it doesn't matter. There's no boundaries
here. This
is
like a tot place that Stefan would describe.
Yeah, the hottest club in New York is tots.
I'm never thinking certainly if I'm going for tots, I'm not thinking I want to put a bunch of stuff on them. That's like an interesting thing that's.
Yes.
I don't think, well, these are a perfect conveyor for other things. They're round. So how are they holding things?
Mm. Yeah, the cylindrical form factor, I think.
That's a great point.
I think it's not ideal. I think fries are better for them.
I think so too.
But because tots are having a moment, as you both were saying, I think that's
I got a pitch for you.
Being the base for these.
Long tots. They're like fries, but they're tots.
They're so long
they're like
tots.
Hash, like the Dunkin' Donuts hash browns, big.
There you go.
Flat guys.
But you
now
know
that
what?
Would work.
But like a fry, like a cylindrical. Long boy.
Like when Burger King did chicken fries? Top fries?
100%. Top
is
fries.
Is that what you're thinking? They're like that sort of girth?
No. I mean,
so
you
soft,
also made
I
a
think.
Hand motion.
they would be flimsy, probably. You know, a tot is a softer.
You think like you're thinking that girth?
Yeah,
no.
Like this? Like, oh, yeah. Oh, I love this.
Yeah, no. I think of more like, like something like that. Small guy. Sorry, I'm sure you guys regret doing the show. I'm saying long tots.
Long tots.
Long tots.
Long tots.
Long tots.
What do you think?
I like it.
It'll be fun.
Long tots.
Sure. Long tots.
Still like small, not like, because like Dunkin's are, I like Dunkin's.
But that's big.
Those are and still a kind of, like I'm saying like fry tots.
Fry tots.
Yeah, yeah. But we're going to call them. Long tots. Right.
Yum. Eat the longest tot. Yum. Eat the longest.
For the longest time?
Yeah, eat the longest tot. I guess for the longest tot is probably, you probably don't need to change eat for the eat.
Yum.
For the longest tot.
Now you guys are nailing that song.
Tots used to be small and kind of round. Ooh.
Now there's longer tots that could be found.
Oh.
What else would I chew?
Ooh.
I'm so hungry for you. I would have a meal of the longest tots.
Wow.
Standing ovation.
That was incredible.
You guys have to get out of here, I know. So
we do a lot of singing improv.
We
on
do
the
a lot
show,
of singing
huh?
improv. We're kind of like off book.
Yeah. Oh, man.
The thinking man's off book.
Yeah.
I want to know, did you guys try each kind of tot?
We got all three.
Yeah.
We got all three varieties.
We got all three
so I'll describe them real quick. Henley, you were talking about they could just put whatever the fuck they want on tots. Domino's has taken that note because they have the melty three cheese loaded tots. Those are kind of your baseline tots. I'll read the menu copy. Golden brown potato tots topped with a melty blend of cheese made with mozzarella, cheddar, provolone, and creamy Alfredo sauce. So you got three kinds of cheeses and they got a little Alfredo on there. They also got a cheddar bacon loaded tots, which is basically the same formula, except they add a garlic parmesan sauce and they add a smoky bacon. And then also the Philly cheesesteak loaded tots, which is tots with slices of steak, creamy Alfredo sauce, fresh onions, fresh green peppers, and a blend of cheese made with mozzarella and cheddar. So yeah, Philly cheesesteak, cheddar bacon, melty three cheese. Those are your options. We tried all three.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Can we first just say, and I think this was Emily, I think this was your observation, a pretty paltry portion, considering these are coming in a big breadstick box.
Yeah.
You just get a kind of like, they're just kind of clustered in the middle. A little softball size portion.
So small in that box.
Yeah.
If they had a smaller box, we wouldn't be talking about it. But
you're 100% right.
The box to tot ratio is off.
A lot more box than tot.
More box than tot.
And I also said, especially for something that's like, they're talking about like loaded tots, like check out this. Oh, this is awesome. Very few toppings, I thought. There were a lot of tots in there that were just simply tots.
100%. Not a lot of tots and a lot of bear tots.
Was that your experience, Henley, or was that our particular Domino's?
No, it was my experience. When I opened the box, I was shocked, and I shouldn't have been.
At the tot-to-box ratio?
At the tot-to-box ratio, I had the exact same reaction. Because also, when you order online, they give a very enticing photo. Of course, this is how it always is with fast food, but nonetheless, I'm always tricked. They give a very. It looks very different in the photo online than when you open it up, and it's like, whoa, <That's> different.
Have you guys ever had the chicken, the chicken bites or whatever they are there?
Yeah, I've had those with the toppings on top of them.
They basically do the same thing. I'll have a little spoiler about my thoughts on it. A better version of the tots. Like, they'll put the buffalo sauce on there with blue cheese, mm-hmm. and then, like, it just works better with those little nuggets than it does for the tots.
I'll agree with you, but I'd still rather have wings. And I think that's the issue with both of these is they're just Domino's throwing a bunch of stuff on there.
If I would want.
Oh, I think Domino's wings are pretty decent. Ellie and I both like them.
Maybe they've gotten better. Look, I'll say this.
Yeah.
To quote the Godfather, Alfredo, you broke my heart. Oh, fucking shit.
I think our guests have a heart out, so let's just.
Alfredo, you broke my heart. Alfredo.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I like it. Yeah. We got it.
I think we all got it. No, I do think we all got it.
Immediately understood what you're
doing. Yeah.
I laughed. No, I thought it was funny.
Thank you.
I really laughed. I think you missed it. She was dying over there.
Look, those ones were kind of, I thought they were like. If these are like your base no meat ones, they kind of just sucks.
Yeah.
These tots weren't hot.
The tots weren't hot.
No.
No. I was so sad. I wanted them to be hot and they weren't. Yeah. I got the cheddar bacon ones and I wanted the garlic parmesan to be ranch because that's of course all
and
I wanted.
That honestly would have been better. I also was so confused about why Alfredo sauce on all of these versions of
strange
tots.
Also the drizzle, it photographs better, but I just want to dip in sauce. That's all I want to do.
Yeah.
Let me dip it.
Yes, yeah. Completely.
Covered
completely
in toppings,
agree.
Give us a dipping sauce.
Yes.
Fill the box. If you have to get a smaller box, get a smaller box.
Yeah.
I just, especially given that, this is like a big promotional thing. They did not invest in this.
Well, because also, to your point,
Do you remember that Sandler song? Like, you got to dip, you got to doodle.
Yeah, I know dip doodle.
Yeah,
that's
fucking good.
Yeah.
I just was remembering it.
Do you remember a reply all email from like 10 years ago? And you got mad. I don't remember what it was, but you replied all to everyone. Hanford, dip doodle these motherfuckers. And then Hanford replied all with a link to the dip doodle video. Do you remember that?
No, that's great. I hope it was like a professional email that we were all on to.
You dutifully knew exactly what you wanted. exactly what you're saying. This is like one of the cheaper things they have, right? Like just like if you're talking about frozen fucking tots that they're just heating up in their deep fryer or their oven, however they're doing it. I think they have a deep fryer there. They
don't, right? Or do they? I don't think they do have.
Do they
a deep
bake
fryer.
Their wings?
Great question.
Whatever
now,
they have
I
in their kitchen,
know.
However they're heating up these, if they're frozen and they're putting in the oven, whatever they're doing to get them crispy.
100% for the nuggets and. I think for the tots, I think they're putting them through the conveyor belt.
Then if they're putting them on the belt, mm-hmm. just load it up with the tots because they're just frozen
load
potato portions.
Up.
Like, get, like, give me more of them.
And it's like you're at Domino's, you have so much cheese.
Yes.
Like,
this is
that's
true.
Where most of your money goes. You've true. Got cheese on hand. Just throw some cheese on those.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was pretty disappointed by all these. Look, I'm trying so hard not to eat red meat. If there's something that we get for the podcast and it's otherwise going to be thrown in the trash, I will have some. And that was the case with the cheddar bacon loaded tots, which I think were probably, one of the few times in recent years I've had any bacon. Bacon tastes extremely good still. But that was the only saving thing of this. Of this particular menu item. And it's just like, okay, you threw bacon on it. Bacon tastes good. What are we doing here? Like, that's like, I don't know. It feels like a cheat and it doesn't feel like I have any reason to get this. The Philly cheesesteak felt like kind of, it's kind of unga pachka. It's just like, you got too much going on. I don't need all this shit. I don't know. Why am I eating tots with like cheesesteak on top of it? Like,
oven baked, by the way.
They are oven baked. Oh. Okay.
I don't think Domino's have deep fryers. I don't think they do.
I weirdly think my favorite were the three cheese loaded tots just because they were kind of like, I could at least see myself maybe having these again in some context if I really wanted tater tots.
Yeah.
Because the other ones were like, they're kind of that midpoint between an appetizer and a meal. Mm-hmm. And it just seems kind of pointless. Yeah. I don't know. What did you think, Mitch? Do you have a favorite? Do you have a pick a pan?
You know, I think, Wags, I think you should fucking email Domino's and dip doodle those motherfuckers. It's fucking ridiculous. I love Domino's.
I love Domino's.
We all love Domino's.
We all love Domino's. Domino's.
That's why they can hurt you.
Wow.
Because you love them.
Wow.
This is just, this to me is like in like the sandwich, like when it's like Domino's is doing sandwiches.
Why do they do sandwiches?
Or like the pastas, you know, like why even the pastas are maybe better.
Nobody's asking for that.
No, we don't need that.
I think they're trying to be like, we do. I mean, this is the issue with every place in the world now, is that like, we got to increase profits. We're going to become an everything brand.
Yeah.
Don't become an everything brand.
I just can't fathom that these tots are going to increase their profits.
It's like Jamba Juice became Jamba.
That's true. They
so
did.
Like,
they have like food?
They dropped the juice.
They dropped the juice. They, yeah.
Oh, sure.
Or all a Weiger right. at a meeting with Netflix. It was coffee, technically, yeah. But... we had a meeting at Netflix during the writer's strike.
We're here to scab. We'll scab. We'll scab.
This is just, to me, is just, I don't even think that they're like that bad or whatever. And maybe if you had like a.
They're not that bad. They're thoroughly unremarkable, though.
Yeah. They're just so unnecessary.
They're unnecessary. They're unnecessary.
They're so unnecessary.
How long they're going to stick around? Like when they release a specialty item like this, I usually ignore it because I usually go to my go-tos. How long are these tots even going to be on the menu is my question, because it feels to me like no one's going to really be ordering these, unfortunately.
They're really focusing on them right now. They still have sandwiches. They still have pasta. They have not discontinued those. I'm looking at the chicken menu right now, and they still have the specialty chicken that Mitch was talking about. So maybe it's cost effective enough for them to just keep the tots on hand.
Sure. And tots are having a moment. Maybe they're trying to get in on the buzzy tots, you know? People
and I could see
but
kids
hasn't the
tot
moment
maybe
happened for like,
these.
Yes.
Kids.
Yeah.
But hasn't, fucking kids.
No,
fucking kids.
Fucking kids.
Fucking kids.
Right. I forget that fast food is for kids. Like, that's really.
Oh, right. Children. Not grown adults. Interesting.
It's for birthday parties. Kids. Right.
Don't you think tots? I mean, I feel like that's like if you're having a party and you get some tots, sure, maybe people will be happy to have them.
Are there multiple size options of these tots, or is it just the one size order? Because that is not a party size tot.
Yeah, this is a good point. You'd have to get like.
They're one size.
You'd have to get like. Seven orders of them, and then also you'd have to put them on you'd have to replate them.
You absolutely would.
This is for like two. This is like for like two people to share. Yeah. It's not a big portion.
Seven of those, but you're filling up your fucking recycle bin.
Yeah, what are we doing?
Anyway,
are they customizable at all? Can you
great
change
question.
Things? Add
a,
things?
That is a great question.
Yeah, you can. I mean, to some degree, you can't like it. I've got it open right now. You can like change how much cheddar cheese blend you want. You know, if you want more or less, or if you want to hold it. But you can't just like add pepperoni or
you
jalapenos.
Should be able to customize them a little bit. I think
that's a great point.
That would make it more fun.
Yeah, if you could make it like a pizza tots, you know, I'm like,
pizza
okay, I'm just going to throw on all of my favorite pizza toppings and see how this tastes.
Yeah. Yeah. I still wouldn't be that excited.
I know. I'd still just get pizza probably.
But some tot freaks might
true.
Be.
Sure. Yeah, that's true. Also, tots have had their moment for like a decade now, right? At least.
I really feel like recently I'm seeing them on menus as like, do you want fries or tots? In a situation where before it would just be like, this sandwich comes with fries.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think they're becoming even more ubiquitous. They were starting to reemerge, you're right, a decade plus ago, but I think now they're just like, yeah, they're fucking everywhere.
Fucking Biden, man.
What's up? Fucking Biden. Fucking Biden.
Fucking Biden.
Fucking Biden.
Pushing this tot agenda.
I blame Doug.
You blame Doug?
I blame Doug.
Oh, yeah. Doug's to blame.
Doug
seems like a tot guy.
Fucking Doug.
Goddamn Doug. All right. We should get to our final thoughts on the Domino's tots, but I want to get everyone's thoughts on Domino's in general because we're all fans. So we're going to get to our fork scores. Right after this break, we'll be back with more Doughboys.
Oh, shit.
Mitch, is this familiar? You got an ailment. You're trying to find a cause for your symptoms. You know, you got like, I'm itchy over here, and it hurts over here.
I got a bad case of wet foot.
Yeah, exactly. What's going on with my wet foot? And then you stumble down a TikTok rabbit hole about wet foot full of questionable advice from so-called experts.
Oh, great. Wet foot is fatal? And in every case of wet foot is fatal?
Oh, I'm going to die of wet foot. It's going to put on my gravestone. It's going to say, killed by wet foot.
I don't want that, but well, guess what, Wags? There are better ways to get the answers you want and the care you deserve from trusted professionals and not random people on the net.
ZocDoc helps you find expert doctors and medical professionals that specialize in the care you need and deliver the type of experience you want.
ZocDoc is the only free app that lets you find and book doctors who are patient-reviewed, take your insurance, are available when you need them, and treat almost every condition under the sun.
When you're not feeling your best and just trying to hold it together, finding great care shouldn't take up all your energy. That's where ZocDoc comes in. Using their free app that millions of users rely on, you can find the right doctor that meets your needs and fits your schedule. Book an appointment with a few taps in their app and start feeling better faster with ZocDoc.
Go to ZocDoc.com/Doughboys and download the ZocDoc app for free.
Then find and book a top-rated doctor today. Many are available within 24 hours. That's ZocDoc.com/Doughboys. ZocDoc.com/Doughboys.
Do it.
Welcome back to Doughboys. We are here with Emily Gonzalez and Henley Cox of Too Scary Didn't Watch. It's time for our fork scores here regarding this particular menu item. But I also want to give just like a general, I think we should give like a fork score for the tots, but I still think we should give our overall Domino's thought because we have a lot of Domino's experience in this particular accord. And I don't think Domino's at large should be punished with the stain of just this, much like the mozzarella stain on Mitch's armchair, should be stained with just the tots. Because there's more to this company than that.
And they should feel free to try things. I want them to push their creativity, you know? So this one didn't work, but maybe the next one will.
That's what we love about
mozzarella stain?
He did. Yeah, I heard that too.
Marinara stain.
I meant to say marinara stain and mozzarella on the brain.
Emma,
can you just fix in the, just like put in me saying marinara over mozzarella in the edit?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Okay, great. Thanks.
Yeah, do like a chat GPT of Wager saying.
Yeah, I'll load it all into, I'll have an AI say it.
Marinara. Okay,
yeah, perfect. Perfect. So here's how this will work. We'll each go around. We'll give our closing arguments, if you will, on Domino's and on the tots. And then we'll end that by giving a score from 0 to 5 forks. Now, I think we do 2 scores. 1 score for the tots and 1 score for Domino's. So you get like, you know, whatever, tot score, for Domino's score, and it's both out of 0 to 5 forks. Henley, let's start with you.
Oh, I get to start? Okay, great. 5 forks is the best, right?
Yeah,
and 0 is the worst, obviously. Yeah. Okay, yeah. I just wanted to triple confirm that. So I guess I will start with my feelings about the tots generally, which was, unfortunately, I'm going to give them a 1. I was not.
A 1.
One fork.
I really was not a fan of anything really happening on my tots. I really wanted to be. I went in with an open mind and an open heart because I have strong feelings about Domino's in general, which I'll get to in a second. But the tot to box ratio, as Emily discussed, also shook me a little bit to my core. Yeah. The garlic parmesan kind of drizzle was like few and far between and like not really enough to satiate my need for a sauce. And the cheddar and the bacon was good. The bacon was fine. It's hard to like screw up bacon though, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
And
that's
so
Barry from Sandwich of History. He's like, a lot of times he's like, bacon is like a cheat.
It's
you
a
know,
cheat.
Like
yeah.
It's a cheat. Yeah.
Yeah. It's a cheese. But Domino's, I give a 5 out of 5.
Wow.
I love Domino's.
5 forker. 5 forker. I mean, I get it. I've gone 5 forks for Domino's
a
before.
A 1 fork flop for the tots, but a 5 fork rave for the chain in general. How about that?
I have a long loyalty to Domino's, and I've been a huge fan my whole life, and it's seen me through so many phases, and I just don't know, you know, when we moved to New York, I saw there was a Domino's right down the street. And I was like, thank fucking God. thank God. So I feel like now in the future, I've got to plan my moves around making sure it's in walking distance to a Domino's because I haven't had to live without one for so long. But anyway, yeah, strong feelings about Domino's, but unfortunately the tots are miss for me.
Mm. Wow. Mm. One fork for the tots, five forks for the chain. Emily, your thoughts, your fork scores.
Okay. I'm gonna give the tots two forks. Really didn't enjoy them, but I was so nervous about them that I can go up from a one. I thought I was going to immediately feel ill.
Your expectations are so low.
My expectations were low in that I really thought I would feel like very sick from these tots.
Yeah.
And I didn't, but I would not get them again. I would not recommend them. But you know, again, I support the effort, and I would love for them to continue thinking. What's next? What's next for Domino's?
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. So I'm gonna give them the two forks for the tots. And for Domino's itself, I'm gonna give five forks.
Wow.
And here's the thing: I'm gonna give Domino's 5 out of 5 forks for Domino's. Like, is it a five fork against any other restaurant? Mm. You're only judging Domino's against Domino's. For me, if I want Domino's, nothing else is going to hit that. If I want Domino's, it's only Domino's, and Domino's is going to be exactly perfect.
We've talked about this before. Yeah. It's that sort of thing of I'm in the mood for pizza or I'm in the mood for Domino's.
Exactly. Yeah. And when I want Domino's, Domino's is exactly
nothing
right.
Nothing else can scratch that itch
and
except for
Domino's.
It's
five forks. Mm-hmm. It's five forks
five
for me.
Five forks, wow.
Yeah.
Look, I think Domino's is five forks for me too. I think
wow.
I think as far as it does, wise, it does what it's supposed to do.
Yeah, it's true.
It's, the app is great.
The app is great. The little pizza tracker, love that thing.
Pizza tracker. Pizza tracker. It's fun.
You get the name of your person making your pizza. Personal touch.
It's, you know, the Noid. We like the Noid. There's a lot of things we like about Domino's.
I don't care for the Noid.
Yeah, I get, you know
the
what?
The way he disrespects pizzas.
That is annoying.
No, thank you.
The Noid is also one of those 9/11 celebrities.
Would have gone down differently if he was on that plane. But he used his giant stamper on the terrorists. Put a pogo stick to someone out of the cockpit.
I love Domino's. When I want it, I want it 100%.
Yeah.
The tots, we're going handholding club here. I'm two forker. It's a two forker for me. It's another one of these the Domino's laboratory. They're going a little too. Sometimes it's your classic. Some stuff works. I mean, the cheesy bread is great.
We love the cheesy
bread, and I think their buffalo offerings are good. You like the wings, and I like the nuggets.
What about their desserts? Do you guys like their desserts?
I think the desserts are even okay. I don't think they're bad because it's like, oh, cool. I like a place that offers you can get like a lava cake if you want one.
I think the lava cake's the winner. I think the but I'm never gonna get those. I just never gonna order those unless I'm trying it for the podcast. And the like the cookie brownie they have is like I don't know.
Yeah. No, you're right. But look, all of those things are better than the tots.
Yeah.
So this place Domino's, which won the Tournament of Champions, The Slice is Right. Which is one of our more revered chains, is on the cusp of re-entering the Platinum Plate Club.
Ooh.
And it falls to me. Mm-hmm. My fork score is going to determine whether it enters those hallowed halls or remains on the outside looking in.
Sick with power.
Wow.
What I am going to say is that we are in hand-holding club when it comes to the tots, because I think the tots are a two-forker. Honestly, maybe in ballpark buds. I think they're one fork, two tines. I think they're 1.5 forks. Because they didn't have a great crispness to them. Oh. They didn't have enough toppings. We didn't have enough. There weren't enough tots. I think
they were
really
kind of cold, which is on us.
A little cold, yeah. But
that wasn't the biggest problem.
That wasn't the biggest issue.
Okay. Fair enough.
I was thoroughly underwhelmed by the tots. Not that I was excited to have them, but
Also, what is Domino's like? We did it. You got tots, and it's like no one cared.
Well, we didn't want this.
Don't think anybody was asking for it. I really don't think this was requested by anyone.
Absolutely not. When's the last time they added something and everyone was like, "Oh yeah, okay."
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean,
when did they add that cheesy bread?
Yeah.
Yes.
So,
but that's just basically pizza.
Yeah,
it's true. So maybe they just should. I don't know. I mean, I guess any chain that experiments, they are always trying new promotions to get people to.
They should try long tots. We do want them to try.
try long tots.
And there's a song at
the
ready.
We got a jingle.
So
I think if they could perfect a dessert, if they could perfect a cookie, just a really good cookie, it feels like they could do that because the chocolate chip cookie brownie combo isn't as good as it could be. Doesn't really work. The malt. I don't really want to eat a molten lava cake all the time, but I would eat it. Not all the time. But if they had a really good cookie,
we disagree on that.
I would be getting that cookie every time I got pizza. You know why not? I'd throw
it. Are you talking, Henley? Do you mean like? Are we talking? We're not talking like a pizza shaped cookie, pizza sized cookie. We're talking like just a regular cookie, like a good oven baked cookie.
So okay. If I'm buying the cookie all the time, it's going to be a single serve one for one cookie. Mm. But there's potential here for them to really corner the cookie cake market.
I'm thinking? I'm thinking a cookie the shape and size of the cheesy bread.
A long cookie. All right.
Like a big rectangle cookie. So it's like the same concept of a pizza cookie, but in the cheesy bread box.
And then everyone at a party could like grab a little slice.
Take
of the
a
cookie.
Little slice of the cookie box.
That's fun.
Yeah.
I like that. That's fun.
I would do that.
Wow. I think the tots are 1.5 forks. The chain?
Oh boy.
Here we go.
I mean, it's about the pizza, right? That's why you go to Domino's.
That's why you go to Domino's. Yeah.
And I'll also say, I like the wings. I think they do good wings. I know they're not known for their wings. I know their wings can be polarizing, but for me, they're absolutely working. And if I'm getting we're getting some pies from there, we're going to tack on some wings. We're not going to tack on loaded tots. We're not going to tack on any pasta or sandwiches. All that other bullshit. We don't need
hit the road.
Get the fuck out of
here.
But if we're talking about Domino's pizza, and again, Mitch, another chain. Hold a Sean Parker, drop the pizza. It's just Domino's. But Domino's pizza, that's why you fucking go there.
Yeah.
I think this absolutely is a five fork chain. So you know what, Domino's? Wow. Welcome back to the Platinum Plate Club.
Wow.
After such a bad outing with the tots.
The tots, you know, were what? The tots made me crystallize what I like about this chain, which is everything else.
And you know what? We had thin crust pizza. You didn't get any.
I didn't have
again.
Any.
But it was great.
It was fucking
we
hitting.
Fucking had, we
that's
loved
really
it.
Good.
I got mozzarella on my chair. we were having a blast with it.
Yeah.
Sus ate a lot of it.
Sus ate most of it. He's sitting where Emily is.
My share, I think, is what he ate. My share.
He was sitting where you were.
Sus,
and he left.
You're lucky Sus didn't eat your share of the tots as well.
If he'd stuck around, he would have.
Yeah.
There were so many crumbs and so much trash in your chair when Susser left.
But no stains.
That's true.
I mean, I'm the one who got marinara on the seat here, but Sus famously spilled ranch on my couch at one point.
Domino's ranch?
No, I would have fucking slurped it off.
I was going to say, it's eating it off the couch. I also want to note that we made this whole conversation. We didn't talk about Papa John's. Didn't even get mentioned. And I feel like growing up, it was the
mentioned.
Papa John's Domino's rivalry was huge, front and center. And
interesting.
Do you guys not feel that way? Maybe that was just...
I feel more... It was more of a Pizza Hut Domino's rivalry.
We're a little older, though. This is like...
But I had a Papa John's phase.
Because they had the garlic sauce first.
They had it first. They had the pepperoncinis, and they had great coupons.
I really liked how the pepperoncinis were so good. And the cheese on a Papa John's pizza, at least at a time, was like... four times as thick as the crust.
Yes.
And I fucking loved that.
Really like that. Really
like. I know you don't like the Noid,
the CEO.
But
really like his politics.
Yeah, I was going to say. Papa John himself is worse than the Noid.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Papa John.
When you said I had a Papa John's phase, I thought you meant like that drunk video.
Yeah, you were Papa John?
Yeah.
That's my Papa John's phase. I don't want to think about it.
Papa John's, I liked okay for like a year or two in college. I was like, oh, this is cool. You can, and
people still defend it. Some people still like it.
I know. So people like it.
That was our review of Domino's. It's time for a segment. Mitch and our guest have a food related quote from a movie.
Wow.
I must guess which word completes the sentence. It's time for meal in the flank. Meal in the flank.
Did you name this or did Amelia?
Amelia named it.
Amelia,
meal
what the
in
fuck?
The flank.
Meal in the flank?
Meal in the flank.
What the fuck? What? Meal in the flank.
You each
meal
get a
in the flank.
Food-related quote from a movie or spoken by a famous person. Guess
my
which,
brain
which
is broken because I
repla-
don't.
Replaces it.
What is
completes the sentence?
Explain
a
the pun here.
Food-related word or a food item?
It's a food word that completes the sentence. Yes. So it's a movie. It's a famous quote, and there is a word that is a food that completes it.
Can you
and
say?
That's
can you
guessing.
Just? Can you explain the pun? My brain is broken. I'm so tired.
I think it's a pun off of meal in the bank.
I think it's fill in the blank.
Fill in the
oh
blank.
Meal in the flank. God. Meal in the flank.
Okay.
Meal in the flank.
What the fuck, Amelia? That's
nailed
insane.
It. Nailed it.
Maybe fill up in the flank?
Fill
in the blank.
Fill up
meal
the flank.
In the flank. That's what it is.
Fill in the blank.
Fill
in the flank.
Bill, I
fill in
the issue is meal
in
filling
flank.
In for Phil.
Meal in the bank.
This made me feel 1,000 times more insane.
Meal in
I
the
feel
blank.
Fucking crazy. Just let's start.
Okay, we're gonna let's play. Start. We're gonna play the game.
Meal in the flank.
Meal in the flank.
Well, you can ring in by saying your name.
Yeah, ring in by saying your name. Okay, first one.
Okay.
This first one's a gimme. By the way, wait, real quick, I do want to. Can you tell us about your podcast real quick? Because it is a movie podcast. You are talking about movies.
It is a movie podcast.
Yeah.
Yes. It is a horror movie recap podcast. Mm. Each week, we cover a new scary movie, and we just truly tell you what happens in it. So it's for people who, I mean, if you love horror movies, great. If you're the kind of person who reads Wikipedia summaries of movies, like Henley and I both have done many times, it's just to take that out for you. You'll have it described to you. Storytelling, but scary and sometimes fucking awful. But that's
wow.
what it is.
Wow.
What can you guys name like your like some of your scariest that you've watched for you personally? What do you think is some of the scariest? You guys, it seemed like you didn't think Exorcist was that scary when I said Exorcist.
Well, we haven't watched most of them.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah, we've only heard about most of them. So
and sometimes hearing about it is a lot.
Sure.
Worse than some, but better right. for others, you know?
There's so many different brands of scary. So if you're going for like demon possession scary, then, you know, there's all the Conjuring movies, which we've had our guest Betsy Sodaro, who's a horror respondent.
She's our Conjuring expert. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She's our Betsy's Conjuring best. Expert.
Yeah, they do a good job with the Conjuring.
But
scary.
You don't usually get too scared with those. The ones that I really find terrifying are the ones that are more like interpersonal. Real like could sure. happen
like a funny games
we
I was
fucking
gonna say
hate
funny
games
yeah. just gonna say funny games that's the top Ooh. One that's top of mind for me because
yeah.
oh
wow.
god it combines the worst possible thing of like people being evil but then also putting someone in such an uncomfortable social situation.
Yes, that was maybe the most uncomfortable to even hear about. We were both just like desperately wanting it to end.
But also so curious. I want to know. I mean, that's why we do it is because we desperately want to know what happens in all of these movies.
Also, just ironic to bring up funny games as we get back to the segment.
A very funny game.
can I guess?
Meal in the flank.
Meal in the flank
meal
is
the flank.
A segment. The can I ask because this episode's coming out at the
Amelia,
end of May.
Amelia, I'm mad at you for the first time ever. Meal in the flank?
Meal in the flank.
Emma, text Amelia and ask her what the fuck she's talking about.
I think it is fill in the blank.
Meal in the flank.
I do have another question because this episode's coming out at the end of May, and we, the Doughboys, at the end of a series we did on our Patreon, Mank, which is the films of Da Finch Man, David Fincher. David Fincher directs some particularly horrific and disturbing movies. Have you ever, do you love Da Finch Man? Have you seen a Seven, for instance?
We've covered Seven. I was going to say, I think that might be our only Fincher that we've covered on the podcast.
Yeah,
Social Network is maybe scarier.
And The Social Network is really scary.
It's fucking.
Didn't he do Gone Girl too? That was David Fincher.
Yeah.
He did do Gone Girl.
Yeah.
We
didn't
Gone
cover
Girl.
That one, but you love Gone Girl.
Yeah,
what
Gone
a great,
Girl's
great,
great
film.
Yeah. Good Meal movie. In the Flank is in fact fill in the blank.
Meal in the flank.
Meal in the flank.
Sure.
Meal in the flank.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
He did Brodiak Wags. We talked about the Brodiak.
Yeah, Brodiak's good.
Brodiak was me. We were playing Jedi Survivor till 4 a.m. together last night.
He did Mindhunter, the series.
That's right, Mindhunter, yeah.
Yeah, we want to talk about more. I think that would be a good one for us to do as like a bonus series potentially on our yeah. Patreon, because sometimes we like to do TV series.
Money in Hill House that way.
Yes, but that's better fit for like bonus episodes. Definitely huge fan of David Fincher. But
loved him. Yeah, well, you loved a Finch man.
Have you done some older movies? Have you done like a?
Yeah, so we're coming Nosferatu. Up on 4 years. We haven't done Nosferatu actually, yeah. But that'd be pretty fun.
Ooh,
so we've
the
done,
scariest.
Done a lot of the favorite. Classics. Done a lot of the classics.
Not in the theater.
The Omen.
Oh, you're talking about the train coming to the screen. That's the Wags ultimate scary movie.
Absolutely terrible.
Train pulls into station.
It's gonna come right to you.
Jesus, get the fuck out of here.
Good God.
Do you think they talk about how people like in the theater, like people like ran out of the theater? You think there were people in the theater like, oh, all right,
calm down, everybody.
Yeah, I think there were some people like, fucking idiots.
We were here before the movie started, and it was a wall.
Okay, so let's play Meal on the Flank.
Okay, great.
Oh, and by the way, speaking of Mindhunter, we covered Mindhunter at the end of Mank with Emma. Emma mm-hmm. has seen all mm-hmm. of Mindhunter twice.
Twice.
A Mindhunter freak.
I loved it. We watched the pilot for our episode, and I have since watched the next two episodes while walking around.
Just immediately hooks you in. Damn. Wow.
Good.
What do you like about it? What is it that
I don't know?
You?
There's something. It's something about just like the way I was saying this on the episode, like the way they talk to each other, the like psychology of it all, and like just the whole concept of figuring out serial killers, like deciding that term and like figuring out the concept of that. Just fascinating to me for some reason.
It kind of like helps her like with her job because
creepy
the people in Mindhunter are less creepy than my bosses. You know, it's totally normal.
All right, here we go. Meal in the Flank. First
meal
quote,
in the Flank.
Buzz in with your name for Meal in the Flank.
Okay.
Here's the quote. A blank, shaken, not stirred.
Mitch.
I heard Mitch first.
Martini.
That's correct. And this particular quote is from Sean Connery as James Bond in Goldfinger.
Nice.
I love gold.
That's Goldfinger. Goldfinger is just like Goldmember.
Yeah. All right, Mitch is on the board with one.
I hung out with Austin Powers back in the day. That's Bill. Did I do that on this episode or was that last episode?
No, that was last episode, which is coming out next week. Right.
I'm out of my mind.
No,
let's
you're
keep
doing
going.
Great. You're doing great. All right, Mitch has one.
Okay.
Next one. This is a Mitch Hedberg joke.
The fuck?
A blank is like a pancake with a syrup trap.
Emily.
I heard Emily.
Waffle.
Yeah.
The answer is waffle. You are on the board. You each have one. All right, next up. Hey, speaking of the Finch man and speaking of Gone Girl. All right, here's an exchange between Ben Affleck and Rosamund Pike. Rosamund Pike's character, Amy. They already relieved me of my artisanal blank platter. Nick, Ben Affleck's character. Finally, someone tells me how to pronounce that word. Amy, blank? Nick, yes, blank.
All I heard was blank, and my brain is like, what? There's a conversation happening?
I'll give the first thing again, okay, the first line again, because this is, Amy, they already relieved me of my artisanal blank platter. It's the same word in all of these. So artisanal blank platter.
Charcuterie? Mitch, charcuterie? I mean, I don't know.
Not charcuterie.
I mean, a charcuterie breakfast platter doesn't make sense, but I just didn't know. I forget.
It doesn't have breakfast.
I was
going to say,
did
breakfast?
Say breakfast?
Oh.
Got breakfast on the brain?
Are you hungry?
I think the tots made me think of breakfast. I'm out of my mind. I'm fucking, I haven't slept at all this week.
My artisanal.
Oh, the waffles. That's what it was.
Waffles. Yep.
Thank
my artisanal blank
platter.
And there's something to do with how it's pronounced.
Finally, someone tells me how to pronounce that word. Blank? Yes, blank.
Oh, that he's probably making a joke about.
I'm trying to think of what's artisanal. A word that goes with artisanal that's hard to pronounce.
I think he's, I just watched this movie a couple months ago. And I do
Emily's
not...
on the right track.
Oh. About the joke? She's making a joke.
I think I know what it is now. but I can't say it again. I'm out. I'm disqualified.
Oh, you're disqualified.
Yeah. Emily Henley wanna take a crack?
Wait, what something did Emily platter? Say that made her think you
I think that, I think you're very close.
Uh-huh. Okay, hold on.
Can I give a hint? I think of what it is.
Artisanal blank platter. Blank? Yes, blank.
It's going to feel so obvious as soon as we find out what it is.
Is it something that... No, never mind. I won't say it because it's going to give it away.
Is it charcuterie related? Would you find it on a charcuterie?
100%.
One might say that, yes.
It might be something Domino's has a lot
Emily?
Of.
Emily?
Mm-hmm.
Cheese?
Not cheese.
Damn.
Oh, shit. I thought it was cheese, too. Yeah, sorry. Yeah.
But that's not hard to pronounce.
I know, but that's a joke.
That's a joke, yeah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah,
wow,
so you're
right
on the right. You're on the right track, but it's just not cheese.
But it's just not cheese.
And they want to take
meat?
A guess?
Oh, I'm out.
It is meat,
oh
correct.
My God. You're on the board.
Artisanal meat
to
platter.
Be fair, Domino's does have a lot of meat.
Yeah, yeah. But the clue was cheese.
I know.
Yeah.
Who else has a lot of meat? Ben Affleck.
That's 100% true. Jesus.
We do have a hard out, so.
That fucking, that box they put the fucking tots in.
All right, next up. This is from Silence of the Lambs. Have you covered Silence of the Lambs?
All right, here we go.
I love that movie.
All right, here we go.
A census taker once tried to test me. I ate his liver with some blank
Mitch.
And a nice Chianti. Mitch.
Fava beans.
It is fava
it
beans.
It is fava beans.
Classic line. You have two.
I will say,
guests have one apiece.
Lately, my partner Joel has been really into making a fava bean pasta.
Wow,
how fun!
And you know, it's great. Just want to say, it's my first real experience with fava beans. We eat it all the time now, so big recommend. You make a sauce with it.
You make a sauce with the fava beans. It's not a fava beans base for pasta.
It's pasta, real pasta.
Got it.
And then you sort of puree some fava beans with, you know, some other. He doesn't.
Don't
not
invite
me,
Hannibal over. Whatever you do,
because he's gonna add something else to the menu.
Yeah. It's true. All right, next.
Yeah, if you were, if you said to Hannibal, like, you can come over for dinner, like, and I want you to make something, but don't, you can't cook human up and serve it to me.
Uh-huh.
Do you think he would listen to you?
No.
No, he'd sneak some human in there.
Yeah,
also,
yeah.
Also, invite him over for dinner. Don't do that at all.
Oh, fucker. I know, but what if you, like, you're like, I want you to come over. I like, I want to talk, you're interesting.
I haven't seen you in a while.
He's an interesting guy.
Yeah.
He's
interesting.
I like everything else about you.
It's like, come on,
won't
come on by.
We just talk about that.
Separate
like
art from artists, sort of, you know?
That's kind of...
All right, next up.
Okay.
This is a Samuel Jackson line from Pulp Fiction.
I heard...
What were you going to say?
No, just that Hannibal Lecter was like, when Armie Hammer got booted from that. Never mind. I was going to say it got replaced with Hannibal Lecter.
I forgot. What a gaffe. Out of the fire or out of the frying pan
into
the flame.
Into the flame, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
All right, next up. This is the same.
I couldn't
Jackson
remember
the
thing
Pulp
that
Fiction.
Armie Hammer got ejected from. Didn't he get fired from some movie? I forget.
Social Network 2. Normally, both your asses would be dead as fucking blank, but you happen to pull this shit while I'm in a transitional period, so I don't want to kill you. I want to help you. Normally, both your asses would be dead as fucking blank.
What movie is this?
This is from Pulp Fiction.
Mm-hmm.
Pulp is in a food. Not a clue for this in particular. Just a little fun fact.
Just a little fun fact. Yeah.
Social Network 2 : Instagram. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
That is good.
Both of your asses would be dead as...
If you would have bought Instagram, you would have bought Instagram.
We gotta go. We need naps or something. Dead man, I should know this. I love this movie, of course. It's a great one.
Owning one social media platform isn't cool. You know what's cool? Owning two social media platforms.
And changing your name to Meta. Drop Facebook, add Meta.
This is what you guys talked about with Netflix last week?
Yeah.
You're
dead as blank. Dead as fucking blank. This is honestly, like, there's a lot of really memorable lines from Pulp Fiction. This is not one of them.
Yeah, yeah, I
can't
remember.
A little bit of a deeper cut. Anyone want to take a guess? Just guess a food.
Dead as, I don't know. Dead as.
Henley, beef jerky.
Not beef jerky.
That's
but it is
fun,
a meat.
Though.
Oh, all right. It's a
it
meat.
It is a meat.
Dead as pork?
Nope, not pork.
All right.
All right.
I feel like I should know this.
dead as dead as
I think I maybe know.
Hot dogs.
Hold on, bacon. No. Fuck!
They do talk about bacon at a certain point because it's like he doesn't eat pork, right?
Mm-hmm.
But no, the answer here is fried chicken. Normally both your asses would be dead as fucking fried chicken.
I never would have gotten that.
All right, we got another.
Did you know that, Casey?
No, I know what scene it is, but I was like, my brain. What could he possibly have said? And I would never have guessed fried chicken.
Yeah, I would have a better time trying to recite all of Ezekiel 25:17 than actually saying fried chicken, because I just don't remember that. All right, next up.
Okay.
Come on, he's insane. Look, right now he's probably dancing around his grandma's panties, rubbing himself in blank. This is Brad Pitt as David Mills in Seven by Da Vinci Man.
Oh, shit.
Rubbing himself in what food? Right now, he's probably dancing around his grandma's panties. Yeah, rubbing himself in blank.
I don't know this either. Mitch Gravy?
Not gravy.
Henley Spam?
Not Spam.
That's good. That's a good guess.
Emily, maple syrup.
No, it's not maple syrup. It's peanut butter.
Ew.
Peanut butter.
Oh, yeah. That sounds familiar.
Yeah. All right. Okay. It's two for Mitch, one each for Emily and Henley.
Okay.
We have two more left.
Okay.
Anyone's game. I would not get this one. I'm just going to say this is an Orson Welles quote. Welles quip.
I think I'll probably get this.
Ask not what you can do for your country. Ask blank. Ask not what you can do for your country. Ask blank.
Not ask for blank.
Ask blank. The game is meal in the flank.
This is Orson Welles?
Orson Welles.
And what?
Orson Welles is, this is like kind of a quip. It's obviously a reference to
right.
the JFK
ask
thing.
Ask what you can do for your country. Don't you, are you going to, you can't. Ask blank. Ask
for dinner.
You're in the right ballpark. I'm tempted to give you a half point.
Oh.
Okay.
In fact, I will. I'm going to give you a half point.
Wow.
Okay, great.
Ask.
For the check?
Not for the check.
Ask, what are we eating?
What's for dinner?
It's what's for lunch.
Oh.
I think Henley came closest. I'll give you a half point
there.
All right, well, last
what's
one.
For lunch? I should know that.
This one's from Aliens.
I know.
This one's from Aliens, Mitch.
Classic movie stuff. Okay.
I guess she didn't like the blank either.
Oh, man.
Shit.
You're going to know this when you
I know. This makes me mad already.
I guess she didn't like the blank either. Have you covered Aliens?
Yes.
Yes. Haley Joel Osment was our guest for Aliens.
Haley Joel, great podcast guest.
Yeah, he was. He did Aliens. He's a great podcast guest.
What a prince.
And also a great person. Oh, he's a great podcast guest.
I only think of people's value in terms of how they are as guests on podcasts.
100%, yeah. Shit.
Can you say the quote again?
I guess you don't like the blank either.
I guess you don't like the.
She don't like the blank either.
I guess you don't like the.
I guess she don't like the blank either.
I feel like it feels like Hicks is saying this, or Hudson.
Frost. It's Frost.
Oh, Frost.
Frost.
Okay.
I guess you don't like the blank either.
Man, I love this movie. I've seen it 100
times.
So
good.
Amelia, these are hard.
They're hard. Meal in the flank is hard.
Meal in the flank is hard.
This is the one that's bothering me the most because I feel like I should. It's like I'm there, but I can't.
Anyone want to take a guess?
porridge.
Not porridge.
Porridge. I was trying to picture. Oh, you know, I'm thinking of the Matrix. I'm like, what are they eating? I'm thinking of people in space eating out of bowls. It's fucking the Matrix.
Is this early on when they were like come out of cryo?
I'm trying to remember the exact context for this one. I don't have it in front of me.
Feels like she's talking about the alien.
Yeah,
right?
that was my thought. It was either the alien, but Frost dies, I believe, pretty early on. Right? Isn't Frost like the kind of the captain guy?
Yeah.
So that's why, like, in my mind, this is like after they're in cryo when they're at the breakfast table.
Coffee? Henley coffee?
Not coffee.
That was not me. Yeah, I guess I had to.
Eggs?
No. I guess she don't like the cornbread either.
Mm. Never would have done that.
Ripley slaps Snocks away the food.
I knew it was in that scene.
Yeah, yeah.
Never would have remembered that.
I knew it was in that
they
scene.
They had cornbread.
Well, Mitch, wow, you have one hard meal in the flank with 2 points. Collectively, we got basically 5 out of 8. But yeah, that was tricky.
Whoever thought meal in the flank would be such a fucking ruthless fucking Jesus. Dear God.
Damn.
That was meal in the flank. What do you wait? When you're watching,
stop saying meal in the flank.
When you're watching a movie,
yeah.
What do you like to snack on?
Ooh.
Weiger is a popcorn skeptic.
I'm a popcorn skeptic. I usually go nachos if I'm in the theater. If I'm at home, I'm usually just locked in. I like a beverage. Because if I'm snacking, I'm getting like the
yeah, I don't really snack at home when I watch a movie.
No.
Did Homer sing Nacho Man?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, I was just thinking.
He had the fucking nacho hat with the dipping in part
nacho,
in the sombrero.
Nacho Man, that's good.
Yeah.
I eat a lot of Cheez-Its. I just love crackers in general, so I will eat any cracker that I have available, but Cheez-Its.
Cheez-Its seems different from a cracker to me. I mean, I know it is a
what
cracker.
What the fuck? Are you serious? It's such a cracker.
It's a snack.
It's a small cracker, so you eat them
when
in handfuls.
When I think of cracker, I think of...
Yeah.
It's just...
It's so clearly a cracker.
I'm tired.
Yeah, but you have to get the family size Cheez-Its because the smaller Cheez-Its are kind
of
a ripoff.
You gotta get that big
extra
box.
Extra toasty. I like a lot.
Extra
the regulars
nice,
are good too.
But I prefer just the regular old
Cheez-It. I get
the default. I love a Cheez-It.
Cheez-Its are great.
They're great.
In a movie theater, and pretty much only a movie theater, I'll do a peanut M&M.
Me too. It feels like almost healthy. It feels like you're giving yourself protein.
It feels like the healthier option. It also is like bigger than a regular M&M. You know,
that's
you can
true.
Sort of just do like one at a time and make your way through. So I go for that.
Yeah, Mitch did the mocap for the peanut M&M.
What do you mean, Red?
That was good.
Isn't it? What's his name? It's
Lovitz.
J.K.?
I thought it was Lovitz. Oh, yeah, J.K. Rowling and Lovitz, right?
No. No, Red's not. No, he's not. That's not Lovitz, is it?
Was it ever Lovitz?
I don't know.
It's Billy West maybe now? I thought it used to be Lovitz.
No. It was never Lovitz. I'm putting my foot down. It was never Lovitz.
Okay.
But I think Yellow was maybe... Who was Yellow? Was am I saying is J.K. Simmons insane?
No, I don't think that's insane. I think it's thoroughly possible. I'm trying to find out who the voice was. This isn't important.
I think it's very important.
The peanut M&Ms are a good choice. I think for like a candy snack.
Did you not
also
find
a little,
it?
A little salty and savory too.
I'm gonna Google it.
I'm finding it out. Red M&M voice.
Yeah.
Actor.
What do you guys like to snack on when you're watching things?
I'm a popcorn.
Billy West. It's Billy West.
It is Billy West. Okay.
What I like to snack on in the theater, I think, is just nachos. Or if I'm really hungry, I'll do a hot dog, a heated dog.
I'll go for a big soft hot pretzel at a movie theater.
Oh, that's
too.
A hoot. What you dipping that in cheese? What are you dipping it in?
I'll do cheese and a mustard.
Oh, hell
so
yeah.
I can go back and forth.
Okay, hold on a second. Red, Billy West, and then J.K. Simmons.
Nice.
Is Yellow. But this is weird because up top here it says, from sources across the web, and then it lists a bunch of people, including John Goodman. And I'm like, Goodman does sound like Yellow.
They might have started with Goodman, because this other source here, behind
John
the
Lovitz
voice actor, says Lovitz was Red for a time.
Billy West is 71, John Goodman is 70, and Lovitz is 65.
Wow.
That doesn't seem right.
Wow.
We're all getting old, huh?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What's that thing you like to say about getting older?
I have a famous quote, the older you get, the shorter life seems.
Wow.
That's deep.
Thank you.
Sage.
Thank you.
That was Meal in the Flank, just like a restaurant value feedback. Let's open the feedback. And today we have an email from Paul. Paul writes, I learned today that earthworms have chemoreceptors on their skin that allow them to taste. A couple questions. First, this is kind of nightmarish for Too Scary Didn't Watch.
Yeah.
First, if you had taste buds on your skin, what food would you make your clothing out of so you could taste it all day? Don't like this scenario. Second, what food would be the best food to eat right before you die to give earthworms a flavorful feast while devouring your flesh?
What the fuck? First of all, you still wouldn't make clothes out of food.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just because you could taste stuff.
I think you would need it to be like
neutral.
Decidedly yeah. not food.
Yes.
Like those like wafer crackers that are not, that like you know what I mean?
Yeah.
100%.
I forget what they're for, but you know what I'm talking about.
I know what you're
tasteless
talking about.
Tasteless little crackers.
If we have like convenient wafer.
If we have to pick a taste yeah. though, I think I'm going something citrusy. I feel like I need something refreshing.
Okay, you know,
it's
like
all
that.
The time. Constant. Yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking mint originally, like, but no, that's no, I don't think that's
all
even
the time.
That.
It'd be overwhelming.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. Like a lemon like, zest.
So if you like got dog shit on you or something, you taste
yeah,
the
you
dog
taste
shit.
It. You step
oh
in
my
dog
God,
shit.
This fucking nightmare.
You gotta go wear shoes. But your shoes
you
better
taste
be,
your shoes.
Your shoes better be made of red licorice or something.
Yeah, I guess I was thinking like you're stepping dog shit without shoes on. I guess is a scenario.
Just
I hate it when that
it.
Happens. Yeah. Man, that's crazy.
Yeah. And what should we eat so that the earthworms have a good time when they devour us? Is that is that part two?
Yeah, I get that's part two. That's the
and that's presuming that we would then taste like what we just ate.
Yeah,
as opposed
yeah.
to
I don't think that's how that works.
Our own bodies, we would just taste like a body.
You know what I think the earthworms, no matter what, when they came into my coffin, would think jackpot. I think they'd be happy with what they
yeah,
found.
I guess the question is, what would you want to be buried in? Like mummified in something for the earthworms? I'm not thinking about the earthworms. I'm not thinking about them.
I'm not thinking about them either, but if I wanted to give them like, I think just wrap me up in like a giant fruit roll-up, that could be fun.
And
for
that's
the earthworms.
Fun.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's I could fun. Just sit in like a hot tub of like cold brew. Because I feel like I could be all right with just like kind of sipping coffee casually.
Oh, man.
Sure.
That's I like
hot
that
tub
idea.
Tub of cold brew.
Yeah. I meant what I said.
Yeah, okay. Sure. I like a cold brew. Heat it up.
Dude, you jackass. That was worse than the fucking cheese it fuck up.
That is very funny.
I think like a big tub of Gatorade or something would be fun.
Oh,
too.
That's a great that's idea. Good. Very
ooh,
refreshing.
An orange Gatorade. Which flavor are we choosing of Gatorade, do we think?
Oh, I mean, don't like, know.
Like Arctic, is it Arctic Freeze is the light blue one?
I think I think the blue flavors would get overwhelming. I think like an orange, something a little bit more low grade, less
orange.
Intense.
Orange
yeah.
is pretty intense, by the way.
Well, it's Gatorade. You know,
maybe I go lemon lime. But then also again, this means that like in this world where we can taste through our skin, which I guess is like a very different world.
Yeah.
That means like we'd be wearing food clothes and also filling up pools with liquids that we drink.
I guess.
I feel like if nothing else changed, I think Emily's yeah. right. We would be avoiding the tasting at all costs.
I'm
we'd
like
be
picturing
clothes
it like you're like
to shield
in
ourselves.
The fucking X-Men universe where like that's your thing and that would suck because you're also still a human, you know?
Yeah.
You shake someone's hand, you taste their hand.
Oh, fuck.
Nasty.
Yeah, what you would end up doing, you yeah. would cover yourself
man.
In like a rubber suit all the time.
Imagine
so
being
as
a
to
fucking
not...
Doughboy's meet and greet in that scenario. Fucking nasty.
Jesus Christ. Can't get the taste
yeah,
of cum out of my
be,
mouth.
That would not be good.
Also, if you were an X-Men, that's like the that's the power.
Everyone's jacking
that's
off.
The
that's
worst superpower.
No, I got what it was.
Saying, like all our fans are jacking off.
It would be very similar to just taste it, to stepping in the dog shit barefoot. I think it would be the same thing.
In this scenario, I think I would step in front of a choo-choo. Because
yeah,
I don't
yeah,
think
yeah.
I want to be tasting things ooh, with my flesh at all
that'd
times.
That'd be the last thing you taste. Fucking steel.
Hey, man. That'd be a lot worse. Hey,
remember
hey,
Earthworm Jim?
Yeah.
Bring him back.
Bring back Earthworm Jim. Did they try to reboot that? I can't remember.
The creator is like a crazy asshole.
He's
man.
A weird fucking yeah. guy.
He's like a right wing
yeah.
dude.
Yeah, I can't remember if they tried to reboot that at a certain point. They had an Earthworm Jim HD in 2010. That was the most recent entry.
Mm.
Hey, if you have a question or comment about the world of chain restaurants, you can email us at doughboyspodcast@gmail.com or leave us a voicemail at 830. Go to that C30-463-6844.
Can I just say, if they're going to bring back Earthworm Jim and make him woke, don't even bother. I don't want your woke Earthworm Jim.
Yeah, we want the traditional Earthworm Jim, the Earthworm Jim we grew up with.
Mm-hmm.
And to get the Doughboys Double, our weekly bonus episode, join the Golden or Platinum Play Club at patreon.com/Doughboys.
Wow.
And hey, if you're looking for more podcast content, on that note, check out Too Scary Didn't Watch.
Hell
Emily,
yeah.
Henley, tell us more about the show, how people can listen to it, and anything else you want to plug.
that's pretty much it. It's Too Scary Didn't Watch. We are also on HeadGum. You can find us wherever you get your podcasts. We come out every Wednesday. And if you want even more than that, we also have a Patreon, patreon.com/TSCW podcast, where we have bonus episodes. We're also doing a Succession spinoff, which is almost over. Some video episodes and things like that.
Any recent episodes of note of the podcast?
We just covered Martyrs, which was a fucking doozy.
Wow. It was horrible.
It was really difficult. Martyrs.
That's a lot.
It was really difficult.
So hard.
Martyrs, you guys, is just intense. It's hard to get more intense than that movie. It's crazy.
I know. It's a double black diamond. We've been gearing up for it for a while. And it was tough. It was tough. But you, a more fun one that you guys just did, I wasn't able to be in this podcast, but you did Final Destination 3 with...
We did. We just did Final Destination 3 with Lauren Lapkus, and it was her first Final Destination viewing ever, which was a really fun way to experience that.
Mitch loves those movies.
Two is the tops.
Two is so fucking good.
Two is the best one.
Two is so funny. They're great.
Two is the highway death scene in is great.
It's but great. We also,
have you seen that, Alex?
We did that one as well.
No, I haven't seen two.
Yeah. We did that
If you want to hear about two, we've got that as well. We did it live in Toronto last year with Lisa Gilroy, and it was a fucking hoot.
Check all that out.
And also we do new ones too. So we did the Evil Dead that just came out. Evil Dead Rise. So we like to cover the ones that just recently come out as well.
Mitch and I are divided on Evil Dead Rise. I think Mitch was more of a skeptic. I thought it was fun.
Yeah, we came out on it was fun, but not as good as the 2013 Evil Dead.
Mm. Sammy loved 2013 and was levitating around the room after watching it and gave it a huge like 5 stars. And so she had high hopes for Evil Dead Rise and I think she had a great time, but it didn't meet her expectations. But it was super fun to hear about. And any horror movie content with children is hard for me, but I made it through. I did it.
Yeah. Yeah. You always wonder if they'll go there, if they'll off the child.
Yeah. No. Yeah. And sometimes they do.
Sometimes they do. Possession.
Jesus Christ, they fucking did it.
We just covered Possession.
That's a crazy fucking movie. Possession.
I've never seen it.
Huge spoiler, Emily.
Spoiler alert.
Sorry.
Spoiler for Possession.
That is fucked up.
Yeah.
I'm furious. I have a heart out.
Thank you both so much for being here. Too Scary Didn't Watch. Check it out wherever you listen to your podcast. And that'll do for this episode of Doughboys. Until next time, for the Spoon Man, Mike Mitchell, I'm Nick Weiger. Happy eating.
See ya.
Want more Doughboys? Check out the Doughscored, our Discord server. Get access to that and the Doughboys Double over at patreon.com/doughboys. Sources for the intro are in the episode description.
That was a HeadGum podcast.